You're watching College Football Primetime presented by Ram Trucks. Who is ready for some action? We are at UB Stadium here in Buffalo as Northern Illinois, coming in at 7-3, 5-1 in conference, is looking to wrap up the MAC West Division. But for Buffalo at 4-6, they are still trying to keep their season alive. If you look at the standings here in the MAC, on the right side, Northern Illinois, one of the best turnarounds in all of college football. This team did not win a game last year. Here they are at 5-1, a chance to punch their ticket to the championship game tonight. Now for Buffalo, with two games remaining, they need to win both to become bowl eligible. What's up, everybody? Welcome inside the booth with my partner, former Auburn center. He's Cole Kubelik. I'm John Triffin. All right, there is so much on the line for both these teams tonight. Now, for Northern Illinois, we spoke to head coach Thomas Hammack moments ago. He told us, we have to win this game tonight. We cannot leave it up to chance. Next week, anything can happen.
John, kind of reminds me of what Dana White always says when his fighters complain about a fight that they lose. Never let it go to the judges. Handle your business tonight. There are a lot of goals that are in front of you. You can take care of those. You don't know what's going to happen with your opponent. You don't know what's going to happen with injuries. Handle everything, and a lot of your goals are put to rest this evening.
All right, so they didn't win a game last year. This year, they're not afraid of close games. They have won six games by one possession.
It's remarkable to think about, one, how young this football team is. When you look just at first and second year players on the roster, and they're able to battle back, stay in, and then find ways to win games. I really do believe you learn how to win games. And when you didn't win one a year ago, what a better way to go find out about yourself and how to win them this year. Game-winning field goals also help. They've had a few of those last week, obviously, getting that Golden Stalker trophy and taking that back to the house. These kids just continue to fight, they continue to play, and they know how to close their opponents out.
I mean, look at the turnaround. No wins last year. They're now 7-3 on the season. That +7 win improvement, that's tied for the best in all of the FBS. All right. Now, let's turn the tables to Buffalo, because for Buffalo, essentially tonight, this is a playoff game, and they're going to be riding the running back, Dylan McDuffie.
Have to treat it like a playoff game, because if you don't win this one, then you might not be playing football after the regular season concludes. When you're rebuilding a program, you need those extra practices. And a lot of folks thought this rebuild, it'd be very difficult to replace Jared Patterson, who went on to the NFL. But the rushing production has not slowed down with McDuffie in between the tackles, catching the football out in the flat, whether it's getting out in space, creating explosive plays. McDuffie, a big reason that that rushing production has not slowed down for the Bulls.
Look at the numbers for McDuffie. He's approaching 900 yards rushing on the season, 10 rushing TDs. These are career numbers for McDuffie. Also, both top three in the MAC. This just feels like it's gonna be a big game tonight. Both teams with so much on the line. Midweek action. Don't go anywhere. Kickoff coming up next.
Tossed.
Buffalo.
Sauced.
Hot honey.
Flipped.
Boneless.
Dipped.
Arby's.
Razzled.
Buffalo.
Dazzled.
Hot honey.
$5 boneless wings and crinkle fries deal. Arby's. We have the meat.
I got you. Don't worry.
I've started guidance.
Let's help you home.
This holiday season, hurry in to the BMW Road Home sales event and find your way home in the ultimate driving machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
I need 3 garlic butter bacon burgers.
It's coming right up.
Will someone grab me some more cheese? Keep that garlic butter coming.
Burger up.
Order up. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger.
Welcome back to UB Stadium. We're getting set for the kickoff. Northern Illinois at 7-3 can wrap up the MAC West title with a win tonight. Buffalo trying to keep their bowl eligibility alive. They need 2 wins to become 6 wins on the season. It is senior night here in Buffalo. And you know the Bulls want to send off these seniors with a win tonight. The senior class, part of the winningest class in school history. What a job they have done for this Buffalo community. They won 2 bowl games here, tons of wins. What an impressive class.
Well, Marlise Linguis was telling us on the field before the game how important it is to him when you have players that have done that much for your program to send them off the right way. He wants their lasting impression of their final home game to be a W.
This will be the 15th all-time meeting between the two schools. Northern Illinois has the edge 12-2.
Now, the Huskies won the toss. They chose to defer, so Buffalo will get the ball first to start this game. John Richardson kicks things away into the end zone, and the Buffalo offense will come onto the field with a little different look. Kyle Van Treese, the normal starter, is out with an arm injury. Matt Myers is the starting quarterback tonight.
A little bit more mobility from Matt Myers. Now, it's not that he can't throw the football, doesn't have the ability to complete passes. Actually has been a starting quarterback within the system, John, so you expect him to be able to handle himself. You're not going to have to cut the playbook down. You're not going to have to limit what you're going to do offensively tonight, but could potentially add some more cue runs, which would be difficult for the Huskies to defend.
And for Myers, he knows that this is his team. Van Treese is done for the season. Now, he does have another year of eligibility back, but right now, Matt Myers, this is his chance to show everybody what he can do. First play, he's going to come out throwing. That is complete on the outside. Jamari Gassett with the completion.
I like the decision to go ahead and let Matt Myers put it in the ball. Go ahead and put in the air. RPO there right off the bat, giving him the option. He sees soft coverage. Take advantage of it.
So a gain of 8 on first down brings up 2nd and 2 for the Bulls. This is on the ground. Dylan McDuffie, the guy we talked about in the open, and there's the first down.
Who have to feel good about the stretch play here early. Outside zone has been a staple for Buffalo for about a decade. And this is a shoestring tackle away from being another big gainer for Dylan McDuffie.
So 1st and 10 from Buffalo's own 39. Myers looking to throw again. He's got a man open and just in and out of the hands. That's Jamari Gassett again. That should have been 6.
That's the direction, John, that we weren't sure they were going to take advantage of, trying to throw the football. The wind gusting right in the face of the quarterback here. That's the one-on-one coverage that you want, and you can't put a ball. In a better spot for your wide receiver. Jamari Gassett going to be remembering that one for a while. Like how aggressive this Buffalo offense is early here.
2nd and 10, back to the ground. Here's McDuffie up to the middle. Lance Devereaux on the stop. All right, it's November in Buffalo, so you know it's going to be cold. But we've been kind of let off easy. It is not as cold as we anticipated,
hold
but
on,
it is very windy.
As cold? John, it ain't even cold. We lucked out in this. We might as well be on vacation in this deal. My brother-in-law, Nico Giovino, is from Buffalo. I told him I was coming up here a few weeks ago about with this game. He's like, oh, God, November, be careful. But this is vacation weather for Buffalo standards.
56 degrees. The winds are gusting, so when the teams are going this direction, field goals won't be easy. Nice pass complete out of the backfield. Dylan McDuffie again, so on the ground now, this time through the air with McDuffie.
We mentioned in the open how he can get you out of the backfield as well. And a lot of times off play action, it can be so effective to hit the back out of the backfield after that play fake. Linebacker's going to get sucked up. You'll be able to get him out in the flag, get him in space.
A gain of 26. How good does this Buffalo offense look early?
Looks great early. Look comfortable. I mean, new quarterback, to be able to have this kind of rhythm and timing, impressive.
Trevor Borland, the tight end, goes in motion. This is on the ground. The first look at Ron Cook, and that goes nowhere. Lance Devereaux again on the stop.
I know that's not a big game, but you mentioned Trevor Borland going in motion, and 34 gets an absolute pancake on that last block. 34 and 44. I'm going to tell you this right now. If my guy PFT commenter is watching this football game, don't turn the channel, because you got a couple of former fullbacks that are playing tight end that will absolutely maul. I mean, they are going to roll guys up. Watch the right side of your screen, 34. Right. Lose him there just a little bit, but that was a dump.
Brings up 2nd and 10, toss to the outside. Here's Cook again, trying to get the edge. Lance Devereaux again on the stop. He's been active, a gain of 7.
Molinich out in front there, leading the way, big 44. I like the quick toss. So what we've seen so far is not a Buffalo offense that's just going to come into this game and have one run that they're going to try to rely on early. We've seen RPOs, quick throws. We've seen backs out of the back into the flat. You've seen a couple gap scheme runs, some zone scheme runs. Now you see a toss, try to get the ball on the perimeter quickly.
Third and three, McDuffie's back in the game, but Myers keeps it himself. Where they spotted, it looks like he's going to be a little short, so it's fourth down.
That's what Matt Myers can add, and I asked Coach Linguist before the game, durability, can he handle it? Can he handle 15, 18 carries? He said, oh, yeah, absolutely.
How about this? Offense stays on the field, fourth and short. McDuffie, and he'll pick up the yard and then some inside the 15.
John, you said it before the game. Playoff game, right? Postseason game? Well, let's go win it if that's the case. I love the call to go for it. Watch the cut late. Just zone cut or duo. A lot of the times you focus it on those double teams. Back's going to hit it backside. Excellent job.
Buffalo enters the red zone here on their first drive of the game. Fake to McDuffie throwing. And a short completion to Gassett.
Gassett making up for that drop a little bit earlier in the game. But what this will do, number one, I think Matt Myers gets a little more comfortable. He'll build some confidence with some of these quick, easy, high-percentage throws. And this will also loosen up the defense. So you got a lot of defenders jammed into the box right now. Four D linemen, usually three linebackers near the tackle box. You want to try to remove one of those backers, open up more run lanes.
Three wide receivers set for Buffalo here on second down. To the ground they go with McDuffie, and he is gobbled up in the backfield. Pierre Opong with the stop.
But that's what we're going to have to watch is, number one, the jet motion that came across. You see that jet motion, Gassett going, one defender runs with him, nobody on the quarterback. Matt Myers able to pull that ball later in the game and potentially get north and south for a big game.
So here's the big test for Buffalo on third and long with your backup quarterback when the defense knows you have to throw. Myers out of the shotgun, gets the snap. Out of the backfield, McDuffie, quick pass, incomplete.
Yeah, that one didn't look great. Feels like Matt Myers rushed this football just a little bit. Even if McDuffie open, got to take a little bit off of this pass out in the flat. McDuffie not even really able to get his head around.
So this is the end of the field where the wind is going to affect you the most. They are kicking directly into the wind right now. Alec McNulty. He's coming on to attempt the field goal. He is 10 of 17 on the season. A 32-yard field goal attempt. Snap, down, kick, up. And it is good. So Buffalo strikes first on senior night with a 3-0 lead over Northern Illinois.
Hi, I'm Michaela, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is that first sip when you taste the peppermint chip pieces, it's like catching snowflakes on your tongue, and it just feels like the holiday season has begun.
Hey, my name is Chandler, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the little pieces of the peppermint that you get. It tastes like it's just the top of the line peppermint. For me, no milkshake is topping the peppermint chip milkshake.
Ow. So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy.
He does exist.
They do exist.
Santa?
America! After the past year-ish, everyone deserves something new. So AT&T is giving everyone our best deals on every iPhone, including the iPhone 13 Pro with its amazing camera. Like everyone that worked from home or welcomed a new family member.
They're all the dogs.
Our deals are for everyone.
It's not complicated. AT&T is giving new and existing customers our best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off the Epic iPhone 13 and iPhone 13 Pro.
Look at this. Total pros. First round draft pick.
Rookie mistake.
Undraftable.
Wow. Look at this. This looks fabulous. Where's my plate?
Franchise player.
Eckridge, you do you.
Welcome to Allstate, where we have all new lower auto rates.
Come along and ride on.
And savings like that make you feel like you won the whole dang thing. Now get new lower auto rates with Allstate. Because better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate. click or call for a lower auto rate today.
Curve ahead. Hey, buddy. Want me to drive?
Why would I want that?
Everyone says you couldn't handle the curve.
Who says that?
Show Tebow a curve, guy falls apart.
Tebow, the curve? No way.
Literally everyone says that.
They're talking about a different thing.
Okay.
Here we go. Halfway through the NFL's biggest season ever. Stay tuned.
Well, there's the normal starting quarterback for Buffalo, number 7, Kyle Van Treese. You see his arm is in a sling. He is done for the season. Matt Myers is the new quarterback. How do you think he did in that first drive?
I feel good about it. I feel great about his poise. Obviously, that last throw, not exactly the tempo or velocity you want to see on that particular route, but handled himself well. Nice mix-up on that drive offensively.
Alex McNulty to boot things away. A short kick fielded at the 25. That is going to be returned to the 29-yard line, and that's where the Northern Illinois offense will come out, led by Michigan State transfer Rocky Lombardi.
Big physical body in the pocket, has the ability to push the ball down the field. He can make every throw. He can create big plays. A little bit of a tendency to give the ball back. And in a game like this, on the road, protecting the football will be massive for Rocky Lombardi tonight.
Another week they'll be without their star wide receiver Tyrese Ritchie, so Trayvon Rudolph has been picking up the slack without him out there. Going to the ground, this is Jay Ducker. Ducker found a crease, but the turf monster got him, but he did pick up the first down.
One of my favorite plays, we actually ran this play back in college, and when we talked to Coach Idenis, the offensive coordinator, about this play, I said, you run the truck play? He goes, yeah, truck. That's exactly what we called it. Basically, if you're uncovered, you're pulling on this play. They want to get everybody out in space. They want to get as many offensive linemen out on the perimeter as possible. That was a good start to it.
Here's Ducker again. Up the middle, that goes nowhere. Interestingly for Ducker, he started the season as the number 2 starting running back. Didn't have the best game against Stanford, so they demoted him to the scout team. He worked hard, fought his way back because of some injuries. Here he is now, the number 1 guy.
I thought it was wild how head coach Thomas Hammack said, hey, you can go from 4th to 1st in a week or two on our football team. He said, we treat the scout team in a very competitive manner, and just because you go to scout team doesn't mean you're done playing for the year. Love the resiliency, though, to be able to bounce back and now become a starter.
Here's Ducker again. Plenty of space. Makes a cut. Will be tripped up at the 48 bar. Marcus Fuqua, gain of 8.
So what you'll see in this zone scheme for Northern Illinois is a lot of the cutbacks are designed based on defensive line alignment. So you see Ducker here right away. Look, he puts that foot in the ground. He wants to go backside immediately. They'll read that based off alignment because they know they can hit it backside.
Well, the big fullback is in the game, Clint Ratkovich. On short yardage situations, they want to give him the ball and just pound it. Rudolph is the man in motion. Lombardi looking to throw, and I don't think they got it. A good stopple by Jamarcus Ingram on the tackle. Trayvon Rudolph going to be a yard short.
Well, depending on the spot, and that may end up being a measure. Just a quick throw out in the flat. You just want to get north and south as soon as you secure that football.
So it is fourth down. Northern Illinois hurries to the line. Ratkovich remains in the backfield. And Maurice Linguist is going to call a timeout for Buffalo. So a big fourth down for Northern Illinois. They need this win to clinch the MAC West. But Buffalo wants to talk things over defensively. Let's see what happens when we come back.
When you spend all year serving others, when you lead by example, you don't just land on the nice list. You get rewarded by becoming the top brand in new vehicle quality in the automotive industry. Celebrate all the good you've done this year at the Ram Black Friday sales event.
Get one full year of no extra cost SiriusXM on us and 0% financing for 72 months plus no monthly payments for 90 days on the 2021 Ram 1500 Bighorn.
What's strong with me?
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 With me.
With me!
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
With me.
Me.
With me.
This is no ordinary woman. She saved money on auto insurance without sacrificing quality.
Is Mom okay?
She's spectacular.
Switch to Amica, a company known for superhuman service and coverage. Get your quote today.
How do Sugar Ray Leonard's feet feel when he gets the proper support from Skechers ArchFit footwear?
Sugar's feet feel sweet.
So you should wear footwear that provides the support we all need. Skechers ArchFit.
I'm on fire. Hot feet, hot feet.
Try Skechers ArchFit with expert certified support.
Other delivery apps add surprise fees. At Domino's, we're giving out surprise frees instead. When you order delivery online, you could be surprised with free food.
I love it.
From Domino's.
It starts with a mother's determination to treat her baby's eczema and grows into a family business that helps thousands more. It starts with an Army vet's dream of studying the stars and grows into a new career as an astrophysicist. It starts with an engineer's desire to start over and grows into an award-winning restaurant that creates local jobs. They learned how on YouTube. What will you learn?
Northern Illinois this season, 81% conversion on fourth down this year. That's good for fourth in the FBS. What do you think about this decision to go for it here?
I love it. Control your own fate. We mentioned in the open, as Dana White would say, don't let it go to the judges. You want to go out and win this football game. You want to take this football game on the road. Play aggressive early. You have a short yardage back. You've had some success on fourth down. I'm great with it.
So the fullback, Ratkovich, comes back out on the field. He is in the backfield for the Huskies.
Keep in mind, this Buffalo defensive line a little bit bigger by nature tonight with the bodies that they have out of the lineup.
Buffalo's down three defensive ends. They were not playing in the game tonight due to injury. Fourth and a little less than a yard for Northern Illinois. Lombardi keeps it himself, pushes across, and his big fullback came behind him to make sure he got that yard.
Extra offensive lineman Pete Niger in the game, 50. Excellent job by Brandon Patton, 58, the center. Let's take another look. Got to stay low. Pad level wins right there. Solid conversion up front by the middle of that Northern Illinois offensive line.
As a former center, you live for this
love
kind
it.
Of stuff.
Yeah, just get down there, bear crawl. Just get your pads low. Pound somebody's quad out.
This is Ducker trying to bounce outside. What a play by James Patterson. He leads this team in tackles. That's now 96 on the season.
One way to take away gap scheme runs is to attack north and south. Patterson reads right off the back. Get north and south. Runs right through a block. And get a ball carrier down in a one-on-one situation. It's a big-time linebacker play right there.
Doesn't it seem like Buffalo always has a star linebacker?
Very often.
Approach 7 minutes to play here. Second and 12 for Northern Illinois. Three wide receiver set. Lombardi working out a shotgun, and he's going to be calling a timeout.
Had some issues with alignment here. So I don't think it's really about the play or the look defensively that you got, but you have to get your players lined up correctly. And actually, maybe a part of the conversation right there. Coach Hammack saying, this guy will tell you if you're on the line of scrimmage or not.
Rocky Lombardi has been so big for the turnaround for this team this year. The coaching staff says he's really an extension of the coaching staff. He knows where everyone is supposed to be out on the field.
Well, he and Braden Patton at center. Patton's going to handle that Mike linebacker. He'll handle the point linebacker. That'll set the defense. But coach is actually telling us that Lombardi can override him, can change that point and sort of reset the defense. That's not something a lot of college quarterbacks can do.
Cole Tucker is the man in motion here on second and 12. Lombardi looking to throw. That is Tucker. And he's going to be pushed out of bounds by Opry Washington.
Nice ball. 5-0 pass protection there from the offensive line. Just man-on-man blocking. You don't see a lot of professional pass sets like that. Professional pass drops, as I call them, in college football. Lombardi can handle it, and this offensive line can handle it. Puts you in a much more manageable situation here on third down.
A lot of the wide receivers a chance to step up with Tyrese Ritchie out, Trayvon Rudolph, Cole Tucker, the go-to guys now for the Huskies. Third and four for Lombardi. Looking to throw right side over the middle. That's Tucker again. And there's a first down inside the 30. Corey Gross, the man, bring him down.
Boy, Cole Tucker, that is an excellent route and a big-time throw from Rocky Lombardi. Understands the timing of when to get this ball out. Nice route, nice throw. You understand the coverage, you got him beat. All you have to do is execute. Hit that slant right over the middle of the field.
Lombardi on this drive, 3 of 3 for 24 yards. Trying to answer the opening drive for Buffalo when they put 3 points on the board. To the air again. That's Ratkovich, incomplete. Not sure that wasn't intended for his wide receiver.
So out of this two-back set, a lot of what Northern Illinois will give you is flow to one direction. So they give you a bit of a play-action look, but then they'll level off the routes. So they'll give you a wheel route down the sideline, and then they'll give you a back in the flat with a runoff route from the wide receiver. Very difficult to see that and stick with that, especially if you're in zone coverage.
10th play of the drive coming up. Miles Joyner, the tight end, was actually right behind Ratkovich. It might have been intended for him. Second and 10. On the ground, Ducker goes nowhere, and here's a penalty flag coming in.
Had a crash off the edge from a pre-Washington 3 for Buffalo. Not sure if offensive players sort of held on a little bit too long.
So that's Liam Sorahan, the tight end, who was called on that hold.
You saw trying to bring that corner crash off the edge, and just in a very difficult adjustment. Your man flashes inside like that, obviously trying to get something on him.
So they declined the penalty. Instead of being second and 20, it's now third and 12. Ratkovich, empty backfield. Dumps underneath. That's the tight end, Joyner. And he's going to be 3 yards short of a first down, a gain of 8.
You got the win here if you want to try to go field goal, and it looks like Thomas Hammack going to go ahead and go with that option. We'll talk about the win a lot tonight, and the gust is absolutely heading this direction. What did he give us, about a 20-yard differential?
I mean, it's
heading
huge.
This direction versus heading the opposite direction of where they could potentially kick it from.
Look at those wind gusts and the flags out on top of UB Stadium. So John Richardson is out to attempt a 41-yard field goal. And he missed it. So Buffalo gets the stop and holds on to a 3-0 lead here early on. It is a playoff atmosphere here in Buffalo. So much on the line for both teams tonight.
You got her the perfect gift. Does it matter if you give her the perfect batteries? Well, does it matter you arranged for the perfect camping trip but bought the cut-rate bug spray? Does it matter you splurged on the recital dress but got her a budget haircut. Does it matter? You organized the dream birthday party but rented a knockoff bouncy house.
It matters.
When it matters that it's Duracell.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
On a joyous Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
By the power vested in me by the city of Fansville, I now pronounce you fan and wife.
Natalie drops back into the pocket. It's a three-step drop. Trish is wide open. Here comes the throw. Oh, Becky with the pick. Holy mackerel. We take a look at it. See that full extension by Becky? Let's go back to the action. Oh! At this point, it's anyone's bouquet. Up next, the garter toss.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
Warm feet and cold hands. Find the fine life, baby.
You think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX350.
$5 for the best kind of wings, paired with the best kind of celery sticks. Crinkle fries.
Arby's, we have the meat.
I want to get Steve a gift that'll get him out of the house, but what?
Save big on fitness watches at Sierra.
Oh, that's great, but maybe something that'll keep him out for a little longer.
Cycling gear for less at Sierra.
And by longer, I mean forever.
Ah. Books about living permanently in a van now at Sierra. And everything you need to actually live permanently in a van.
Let's get moving. Beat it, Steve.
Hey, we're the Oscars. Oscar Insurance is great for families like us who are in and out of the doctor for the 100th time with some fun new bug the kids brought home. Where are we always going, kids?
The doctor.
How much does it cost with Oscar?
Nothing.
How much would it cost with our old health insurance?
Loads.
Where'd you hear that word, Jada?
Yeah. Jada.
With Oscar, the entire family gets unlimited primary care visits, all for $0.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Ram Trucks, Motor Trend's Truck of the Year for the third year in a row.
That's earlier this season. The trip Buffalo football team took a trip to Niagara Falls, natural wonder in their backyard. Meyer scampers on first down. A good gain of seven. C.J. Brown takes him down.
We were told to be on the lookout for Matt Myers to potentially drop that shoulder a couple times in this game. You see right away, not afraid of contact.
Myers to the air, off the mark. He was looking for Dominic Johnson. Just to wrap up that story, so when Coach Maurice Lingus took this job, he had 115 days to get his guys ready for their first game. He said one of the biggest things we need to do is team building. He asked his guys, how many of you have been to Niagara Falls? Only about 20 players on the team raised their hand. He said, you know what? Let's get some buses. We got to take advantage of what's in our backyard.
Absolutely. Got to go check it out. Got to go see it. Last time I was here, Matt Barry and I had a very romantic trip over to Niagara Falls. It's beautiful.
So third down for the Bulls. Myers keeps it himself, emerges from the pack across the 50. A gain of 24 for the junior quarterback.
Boy, sneaky from Matt Myers. Following Jake Molinich, big 44. We'll talk about him a lot tonight. Watch him kind of duck back behind the line of scrimmage there and just get north and south.
Now Buffalo using some pace on offense, going no huddle.
Have the defense and a look that you like, have the personnel grouping on the field you like. You can take your time now to get a different play in.
Myers to the air, quick throw outside. That's Keon Williams. He was a big get for this team. Grad transfer from Eastern Michigan. He's been productive.
He'll go over 800 yards receiving on the season in this game tonight. We've already seen the shot plays from Buffalo, so they have proved to the Huskies that they will take those plays down the field. But you're going to play off. We're going to make you come up and play us tight. You want to get those one-on-ones.
Second and four on the ground. This is Myers keeping it himself. I mean, he fooled me out. What a changeup between the two quarterbacks. Van Treese was more of the drop-back passer, but Myers is not afraid to run it.
Well, you're going to force this defense to play it. They want the front side runs to open up, but this is the best way to get the looks that you like. And a pretty good read there by Myers, being able to pull that ball out, get flat, be able to create some space. Ivan Davis, defensive end for Northern Illinois, doing a good job coming back down to help out on that play.
All right, third and inches. Where do you go here if you're Buffalo? All right, while they review this play here in Buffalo, let's talk to the toss of the guys in studio, Phil Murphy, Trevor Maddich.
Thanks so much. We're going to head over to Muncie, Central Michigan, looking to keep the pressure on NIU in that West Division. Daniel Richardson, 47 yards up top to Ja'Cory Sullivan. Sullivan's eighth touchdown reception in as many games. John Cole, it's 7-all over on ESPNU.
All right, Phil, appreciate that update. All right, so the review is for the spot of the ball on that last play.
So we'll go back to what you asked, the question of which direction do I go? Mobility at quarterback? Nice, like that. Have an appreciation for that. But you have Dylan McDuffie on your roster. And a run game that's been going here early, I'm giving it to my best back.
Myers, four rushes, 36 yards already. He's averaging 9 yards a carry.
And that will force the defense to adjust. Your ends are going to have to play out a little bit wider. And you see there being on top of a defender may actually push that spot past the first down marker. Your ends are going to play a little bit wider. Obviously, your alley defenders now have to be aware that a quarterback keep is always going to be a possibility. And I think your safeties roll down a little bit faster, too, when your quarterback has the ability to run.
So we had to get...
Third and short.
So third and short for Buffalo. This is their second drive of the game. Started off with a field goal. They're going into the wind, so this could be four down territory. McDuffie is the man in the backfield with Matt Myers on third and inches. McDuffie gets the carry, and look at that hole open up by the offensive line.
Not sure if Jeffrey Griffin, eighth defensive tackle for Northern Illinois, maybe jumps gaps here, gets out of his feet. You see him come to the top of your screen. That really opens up some space for Dylan McDuffie.
So first and 10 from Northern Illinois' 30. McDuffie gets the carry again, bouncing off tackles. That is a tough gain of three.
Yeah, gap scheme run there. Had a couple pullers. Not sure if an offensive lineman tripped on quarterback Matt Myers or bumped into one another. A little penetration from the defensive lineman, but got off track early. Fortunate for the Bulls that that even goes for positive yardage.
Buffalo already with 67 rush yards on the ground in the game. Second and 7. To the ground again. This is Ron Cook. And looks like a gain of 1 on that right side.
So now you get down close to the red zone. Third and a little bit long here. Not necessarily comfortable with a lot of your run game. Think about the targets you have available. So you have two tight ends in the game, 34-44, both going to stay in. Make an adjustment at running back, and now Northern Illinois going to substitute.
Well, their leading receiver, Keon Williams, is at the top of the screen. Ron Cook is in the backfield with Myers. And Buffalo is going to call a timeout here on third down.
32nd, charge timeout. Buffalo, their second of the half.
Saturday, we'll have another giant game in the Big Ten. Number 7, Michigan State takes on number 4, Ohio State. This one's at the Shoe in Columbus. First place in the Big Ten East is on the line. It's a noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific start on ABC and the ESPN app right after College Game Day on ESPN.
I'm interested to see two aspects of these two teams that aren't necessarily the strengths and who can react best. Kenneth Walker maybe having the best season of any running back in college football this year. That Ohio State front seven has not been the same. It is not what we're used to seeing in Columbus. And that young man right there can flat out get it done on the ground. On the flip side of that, that Michigan State defense has not been great against the pass this year. And you know C.J. Stroud and the best group of wide receivers in the country probably seeing a lot on film that they like potentially to be able to go out against Sparty and put the ball up in the air.
So basically you're saying it's going to be a good game.
I hope so, and I think so, yes.
All right, here we go. Third and six here back in Buffalo. Fake the toss. Myers rolling out to his right. He's going to keep it himself and get out of bounds. A gain of two, so it brings a fourth down.
That's a nice job by hanging on to that football, though, because Lance DeVoe, outside linebacker number two for Northern Illinois, he was right there on the fake. They were trying to take Trevor Borland, slip him back out underneath the line of scrimmage with a little quick bootleg. It was not there. Not much of an option there for Myers. Good read to just hang on to it, get the field goal attempt.
So Alex McNulty comes back onto the field. This is a 42-yard field goal attempt for Buffalo. McNulty made his first field goal already today. Kick is up, and look at that wind. It just died up there short. No good.
That gives you a great look at why this was such a big deal for both of these coaches coming into this game. And Thomas Hammack talked to us about it. He said the winds are going to be swirling. We're going to have to think about our decisions. And we mentioned it before. He said they had a 20-yard differential on kicking this direction as opposed to the opposite direction. Now Buffalo gets another shot. McNulty cannot push that one through the wire.
This is the end that's going to be tough for kickers. Directly into that wind. And now if your head coach Maurice Lindquist going forward, do you think about going for it on fourth downs going this way?
If you're heading that direction, I think you have to, John.
So Northern Illinois takes over. Faking the handoff to Ducker. Lombardi keeps it, throws. Open is Tristan Tavis. But incomplete.
Boy, some of the play
action. Liam Sorihan.
Some of the play actions early for Rocky Lombardi in Northern Illinois really work. And you see the emphasis on the run game from the Buffalo defense. Nice play fake. With those heavy play actions where a quarterback turns his back to the defense, you just don't see a lot of those anymore. It's a really nice job, confidence of Lombardi to come out of that, deliver a good football. You just have to come up with it. Had to catch it.
...30 seconds to play here in this first quarter in Buffalo. Lombardi does complete that to Cole Tucker over the middle. Gain of eight.
I'm a little surprised that we have not seen Northern Illinois go at this Buffalo defensive line early on. Hasn't been near as much motion and movement pre-snap as I thought that we would get, trying to steal some of the eyes of the second level of that defense. And that's just a D-line that's extremely banged up, and I don't feel like they've been tested here early.
This is the end of the first
That'll
quarter.
That'll do it for the first quarter here in Buffalo. The Bulls have a 3-0 lead. They need to win this game to keep their season alive. But Northern Illinois trying to wrap up the MAC West.
Domino's new oven-baked dips are so new that we made a new commercial about their newness. Try new flavors like our cheesy marinara, baked apple, or hot and melty five cheese with our not new but still delicious twists. Carry out Domino's new oven-baked dips and twist combos or any three-topping pizzas for $7.99 each.
Okay. One dad.
I just got into the house.
One mom. Three kids. One pack of Ben's original jasmine rice. One pinch of chaos. We're all original recipes.
I could maybe eat two cheeseburgers
and a cherry lemonade.
Oh, yeah. What size? Root 44?
Go big or go home.
Go big or go home.
And if you're going to do it wrong, do it right.
Well, if you're going to
eat the dessert.
Eat the dessert.
Buy the shoes.
Besides, the drink is half off.
You have too many shoes.
I know.
This is the first photo of your life, son. Your first smile. Your first bath. The room we made for you. And you'll meet Nana and Grandpa. I can't wait for the world to see you like I do.
Searching for meaning in a relentless world, always connected, but somehow
alone, trapped by illusion. We offer another path, where the battle to belong begins. Awakened by a calling, united by the cause you fight for, no one can take away what it means to be among the few, the proud, the Marines.
When I look at my ring, I see the moment that he incorporated my dad.
He was there with us because the letter was in my pocket, right next to the ring.
Mr. Cuesta, let me start by saying that you certainly left a mark on this earth. May I marry your daughter? It is more than a ring. It's love.
Express your extraordinary love. Save 20% store-wide. Jared, love brilliantly.
We buy so many different things online, from shoes to socks to shoe socks, baby food, dog food, parrot food, a scarf, the scarf tube, sleeping bag, suit, huh? So why not tires? At TireRack.com, you can find, buy, then have your tires shipped to one of our trusted independent installers for safe, easy installation. Right now, you can get this special offer when you buy a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. TireRack.com, the way tire buying should be.
The road home for the holidays, where the ultimate driving machine becomes the ultimate cruise through three states machine. The ultimate zip around the corner for mom's cooking machine. And even the ultimate we couldn't get out of there any faster machine. Because at BMW, we know every holiday looks different. So we created the ultimate whatever your road home looks like machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
Frequent heartburn? Not anymore. The Prilosec OTC 2-Week Challenge is helping people love what they love again. Just one pill a day, 24 hours, zero heartburn. Because life starts when heartburn stops. Take the challenge at PrilosecOTC.com.
Michigan State, Ohio State, Saturday at noon on ABC.
Welcome back here to Buffalo. John Schriffen alongside my partner, Cole Kubelik. It is third down for Northern Illinois. Clint Ratkovich, the man in the backfield. He does get the carry. And he puts down the shoulder to pick up the first down. James Patterson was there on the stop.
Tristan Tavis, 82 at tight end. A nice block coming flat across the line of scrimmage. Gets the kick out that allows for big 25 to bull ahead for first down yardage.
Back to the ground. This is Ducker. Picks up a good gain, a gain of six. This is the second possession of the game for Northern Illinois. Their first drive, they missed a field goal. So they're trying to put points on the board here.
Duo's the run play here. And this, I'll tell you, John, this is one of the most complex run schemes of any offense that I have studied this year. They carry everything. Gap scheme, toss, zone, inside, outside zone, truck play. They run it all. Duo there, just a play. You're emphasizing the double teams, scheduling it to hit backside.
Second and four. Ducker goes across the left side of the line, and he will be dragged down a yard short by James Patterson. So defensively, you know they're going to run the ball, but with so many ways they can do it, how do you stop it?
You just have to fit it correctly. And a lot of what they'll also do is they'll give you that motion, that movement. You'll get some heavy packages. Obviously, you'll overload certain sides, and that makes it even more difficult. You see here a couple extra offensive linemen coming into the game. That makes it difficult to know where to line up, where the strength is, how personnel are going to fit certain runs. Look at this formation. You got to love it.
Big bodies.
Talk dirty to me.
On the line. Third and one. Ratkovich puts his head down, and what a collision. Buffalo gets the stop. No gain. Damon Williams, I mean, he's a guy who is in there because there's three defensive ends who are out with injury for Buffalo, and he's been moving around on that defensive front.
Well, that is big-time penetration up front from Williams and Rodgers. A thin defensive line, some new faces in the lineup. That's a great job up front by that Bulls defense.
Northern Illinois is 1-for-1 on fourth down so far this game. They're going to go for it on fourth and one from the 49. Ratkovich makes a cut, finds the crease, and picks up the first down. Josh Rogers on the stop.
Nice job outside, Liam Sorahan at tight end. You'll see big 83 with that kickout block. Watch the left side of your screen. 83 waits, climbs, 65 comes around. Logan Chernitz, good execution up front, short yardage situation. That's a must-have moment for the Huskies.
I love how you show love to the guys who don't have the ball.
That's what makes it happen.
Quick pass to the outside. Messiah Travis pulls it down. A gain of 12.
You see how quick Lombardi gets it out. I mean, just big-time poise, that big body. But he understands where he's got to get the football to. He can get it there in a hurry.
No huddle for the Huskies. Ducker bounced back. Will not make it back to the line of scrimmage. A loss of one. James Patterson, he has been so active early on.
And this is him lined up at defensive end. So watch big 95, normally a defensive tackle. Bottom of your screen, slant inside. You put normally a deep tackle on a tight end one-on-one, and you're giving him a one-way go? That's not happening for Miles Joyner. I'm sorry. That's just, tight end's not making that block. You are not reaching a deep tackle out at D end who's slanting across your face.
Damon Williams, this is the first game he's ever playing at defensive end. Lombardi to the air, wide open is Cole Tucker. And the middle of the field has been open on passes for the Huskies tonight, a gain of 15.
If you can attack the middle of the field through the air, you're going to open up a lot for your offense. Now, first thing you need, quarterback with confidence to be able to do it. Rocky Lombardi proved he's got it tonight. Good protection up front.
Lombardi looking, end zone! Incomplete. Messiah Travis had a step on Isaiah King, but couldn't reel it in.
And keep in mind, Joe Cawthon told us, defense coordinator for Buffalo, I am concerned about the cornerback position. Well, he gets one on an island here. Lombardi puts that ball, oh, right on the hands. Got to make that catch. We've said that multiple times now about the Huskies tonight.
Thomas Hammack told us before the game, we have to win tonight. We cannot leave it up to chance next week. Anything can happen in the MAC. Second and 10. Ducker with some patience. That's hard to teach for running backs.
Not just the patience, but the ability to read. And one thing that these backs for Northern Illinois do that's different than a lot of other backs is they actually pre-snap read the defensive lineman and where that alignment is. So if they're running left and there's a three technique, outside shade on a guard, they probably know that that thing's going to bend back inside a little bit more than normal. So they'll go ahead and cut it back early.
13th play of the drive coming up for Northern Illinois on third and three. Ratkovich, the fullback, is at the bottom of your screen. Now he's coming in motion. Faking the toss. Keeper is Lombardi. And the quarterback picks up the first down, a gain of four. Ingram on the stop.
Excellent awareness from Rocky Lombardi, just understanding down and distance. Good play fake to the jet. Remember earlier in the game, we talked about that jet not necessarily being covered. They'd have a chance to keep it and get north and south. Lombardi does there and doesn't try to do too much. Knows where the sticks are. First down yardage and get down.
So the Huskies now in the red zone. Ducker is the running back. Gets the carry. And look at that disruption in the backfield. Damon Williams playing a new position, having himself a ball game.
And here's the thing about a D tackle, and this goes really for any Husky football player. I can say that because I know that I was one. Everybody loves moving out. Nobody likes moving in. Like, all offensive linemen want to play tackle. All defensive linemen want to play end. So if a coach comes to you and says, hey, we're thinking about bumping you out, all of a sudden the juices get flowing a little bit. You're feeling good about that. You're feeling loose, like, oh, I got moves, swim, rip, spin.
That's the fourth tackle for loss in the ballgame already by this Buffalo defense. Second and 12. Lombardi outside and another drop. That's Miles Joyner this time.
Nice job by Lombardi getting this ball out quick. This is a new look from Buffalo. Haven't run a lot of three down. Both outside linebackers walking up here. You're almost kind of showing a five down look. A lot of D coordinators doing this now. They want to cover up all five offensive linemen, force them to block man across the board.
Lombardi is 7 of 11 today. His only incompletions, the four already by these Northern Illinois receivers.
He's been on target. And he's had the protection. He's had the time. He's had a good awareness of where to get the football.
So third and 12, where do the Huskies go here?
I mean, for me, it's you got to try to get the ball to one of your playmakers on the perimeter.
Has time over the middle. That's Cole Tucker. He'll be short of the marker. Dragged down at the 12.
Why not go back to the middle of the field, though? You've had so much success with it. It's a nice job there. Offensive coordinator Eric Eidness understands that they've had some space there throughout the course of the game. Don't quite get to the sticks, but you at least give yourself a chance. I mean, just look at those goalposts right now, just swaying back and forth. Flags just flailing all over the place. Looks like one of those wild inflatable men outside the track phone cell phone store, out of the burner phone store.
John Richardson from 30 yards away, and it is good. The wind pushing it through. We are all tied up at 3 apiece here. Second quarter in Buffalo. We'll be back after this.
Time out of the...
This season, with our friends at the College Football Playoff and Eckrich, we're going to award a national tailgate champion.
Share a photo of your best tailgate, then just sit back as America votes. Are you the national tailgate champion? Eckrich, you do you.
Find a utopia free of funk with Funk No Underwear. Only at Duluth Trading.
The ride of your life is closer than you think. For the first time ever, buy your new car entirely from home with Nissan at Home. Delivered direct from dealer to driveway.
This holiday season, remember the trick. The one that lets you skip the line and get your finger-licking chicken finger-licking quick.
It's finger-licking quick.
Join Peyton and Eli on ESPN2 and ESPN+.
How much lettuce can you get in one bite?
As they welcome special guests and break down the game.
How would you talk smack to Peyton?
The Colts cut you.
Monday Night Football with Peyton and Eli on ESPN2 and ESPN+.
Think outside the oven and get Thanks Grilling with Ace. Get a Traeger grill to make tasty turkey and desserts. This week, take advantage of great deals on Traeger with free assembly and delivery on all grills $3.99 and up.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Hinge is the dating app that's designed to be deleted. So meet someone on Hinge, and we'll gladly meet our end, which is exactly the way we want it.
I chose this life, and I chose to do everything I've ever done.
No!
She's innocent. I had to do anything to help my mother. You're always gonna have to pay a price.
Be very careful.
I deserve what I get.
Watch Starz Originals and more on Channel 525 or on DirecTV On Demand.
That last drive for Northern Illinois, 17 plays over 7 minutes on the clock, but Cole, he only came away with 3 points.
Yeah, obviously, not just points at a premium tonight, possessions, John, going to be at a premium tonight. We're almost halfway through the second quarter. We've seen 4 total drives in this game. So don't know how many opportunities you're going to have.
We're used to Maxion just being up and down the field. The overs are usually a gimme. Maybe not tonight. So John Richardson kicking things away. A low line drive kick will be fielded at the 20. So Buffalo will have decent field position. They will come out to the 30-yard line. We are all tied up at 3 apiece here in Buffalo.
Welcome to Allstate, where we've just lowered our auto rates. And savings like that follow you everywhere. Now get new lower auto rates with Allstate. Because better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate. Click or call for a lower auto rate today.
When you hear the call of the wild, answer with a pair of Skechers. Waterproof, insulated, all-day comfort. From backwoods to city streets and everywhere in between. When you get outdoors, get into Skechers boots.
You got her the perfect gift. Does it matter if you give her the perfect batteries? Well, does it matter you arranged for the perfect camping trip but bought the cut-rate bug spray? Does it matter you splurged on the recital dress but got her a budget haircut? Does it matter you organized the dream birthday party but rented a knockoff bouncy house?
It matters.
When it matters that it's Duracell.
What's strong with me?
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 With me.
With me!
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
With me.
Me.
With me.
You think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX350.
Tossed.
Buffalo.
Sauced.
Hot honey.
Flipped.
Boneless.
Dipped.
Arby's.
Razzled.
Buffalo.
Dazzled.
Hot honey.
$5 boneless wings and crinkle fries deal. Arby's, we have the meat.
When you have nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea,
try Pepto-Bismol with a powerful coating action for fast and soothing relief. Pepto-Bismol for fast relief when you need it most.
Great guest list for the Mannings tonight.
You've reached Peyton and Eli. Leave a message.
What's up, knuckleheads? It's Chuck. I'd love to do the show again and bring Shaq with me this time.
Watch Peyton and Eli. You never know who'll drop by.
What a great show. I mean, in the first season, they have nailed it. Peyton and Eli, with all the guests they have come on, I mean, those guys have fun with it.
It is a blast to watch because for a football nerd like me, you get them to dive into the X's and O's every now and then. Peyton gets going off on a little bit of a tangent, and then obviously they know how to have fun. They know how to loosen it up, be entertaining. Mickelson was great this past week. I didn't realize he could rifle the ball the way that he could, but the golf glove throwing the ball on the throwing hand was a little bit weird.
Kevin Marks fakes the pitch. He's got a seam on the left side, dragging a defender with him, and picks up the first down. It is hard to believe this is just the fifth drive of this ball game for both teams.
It is, and that's why we said not only points at a premium, but also possessions, as you'll see Marks on a little bit of a gap scheme run. Excuse me, just outside zone, but he fakes the end around. That's going to freeze the eyes of some of the linebackers. Nice play design there.
This has been the opposite of Maction. We've seen four drives, four field goal attempts, just 6 points. Jamar Gassett gets some space inside the 25. Nicely drawn up play, a gain of 38 for Buffalo.
You want unselfish football players. I love the fact you go to Jamari Gassett after he drops the pass early in the game. Watch five right here. Whoop. Go low, get the defender on the ground. That's after Kevin Marks just gives you a first down by carrying the football. He's asked to come right back, block a defender out front. Excellent job by opening up the alley and creating an explosive play.
This Buffalo offense, they're seeing success not just on the left, but also the right side now. Back to the ground. This is Marks staying over that right side. A gain of one. Michael Kennedy on the stop.
And just remember, coming into this game, this Northern Illinois defense allowed 209 rushing yards per game, 119th in the country, John. That means there's not too many more that allow more than you do.
Ah, okay. Gotcha.
Not ideal.
Second red zone attempt for Buffalo. I mean, we knew they were going to run the ball coming into this
Absolutely.
Game.
Absolutely.
They are sticking to the game plan here early on in this first half. Under 7 minutes to play here. Myers with time, crossing over the middle as Dominic Johnson gets to the outside. and he'll be knocked out at the 7. Another first down, again a 9.
One of those big, long targets. Almost reminds you now of Tyree Jackson playing for the Eagles. A little tight end, former Buffalo quarterback, super athlete. Going across the middle there. Nice grab. Those are the bodies you want down in the red zone. Big 6'5 target. Obviously, if you need a jump ball, you can loft it up there, can go attack it, but obviously showed you there, can work the middle of the field as well.
Dominic Johnson, he converted from quarterback prior to the 2019 year. This is his best year he's having right now at wide receiver. Myers hands off to Marks. Marks will carry inside the 5 down to the 2.
You've seen a couple of guys sort of in that same mold be able to do it. You go back and think about when Tyree Jackson was here, just what an elite quarterback prospect he looked like he was going to be. Speed. I mean, he looked like Cam Newton when you watched him play football. And had to make that move down to tight end. Terrell Pryor, a guy at Ohio State, who made that move, able to be successful at that sort of hybrid receiver tight end position for a while.
Marks again up the middle. And he's in there. Touchdown, Buffalo, our first touchdown of the ball game.
Getting on the field is a touchdown.
Watch the push in the middle of this offensive line by the Buffalo Bulls. Just inside zone play. Look at 59 and 62 right there on the left side of that offensive line. Jake Fusak climbing the ladder to the second level. Really nice
rolling
job on that double team.
With a touchdown. That ruling is under further review.
Now they will review that last play, but as it stands for Kevin Marks, that is his 6th rushing touchdown of the season. Buffalo, that is their 29th on the ground.
I'll give you another look here.
And for Kevin Marks, if this stands, he would tie for 2nd all-time in rushing touchdowns in school history.
This might be a good look. The hip is on the ground, but it's a little bit difficult to tell exactly where the football is. So indisputable video evidence. Not sure if the replay booth is going to get exactly what they're looking for to be able to overturn this. You see right there, it looks as though calf, hip, quad, maybe down on the ground, and ball not necessarily over the goal line, but is it enough? And there it looks like he's down and the ball has not yet crossed the goal line.
So you think they're going to reverse this one?
I think probably bring that back because of a couple pieces of the lower extremity look like they're on the ground before that ball crosses the plane.
After further review, the runner's knee was down with the ball short of the goal line. It'll be 3rd down at the half-yard line.
Nicely done, Cole. So that brings up 3rd and goal for Buffalo. Stick with the game plan, just pound it up ahead.
I don't know why you would change much here, Johnny. You had a little success being able to get in there. Pretty good movement from the left side of that offensive line. I try to just play bully ball again. Ram it in.
So instead of Marks, it's going to be Dylan McDuffie in the backfield. Keon Williams, the leading receiver on this team, he's at the bottom of your screen. 5:36 to play here in this first half. We're all tied up at 3. 3rd and goal for the Bulls. It's McDuffie over the top, and he is in there. The leap does the trick, and this touchdown will count.
And this is practice. You usually bring out the big mats and the running backs just run and take off into the mats. Excellent job by Dylan McDuffie. Offensive linemen all go low. They're just cutting across the board, kind of a bear crawl, just trying to shoot forward, get those defenders down. McDuffie has his choice of which gap he wants to sail through.
For McDuffie, his 11th rushing touchdown of the season. Alex McNulty's extra point is good. And Buffalo, and essentially a payoff game for the Bulls. They take a 10-3 lead with under 5:30 to play here in this first half.
Time out of the field.
Surprise! freeze are coming! Domino's has surprise freeze!
Other delivery apps add surprise fees, but Domino's is adding up to $50 million in surprise freeze to online delivery orders. And we tried some unique ways to tell people they're getting free food.
From Domino's!
The road home for the holidays, where the ultimate driving machine becomes the ultimate cruise through three states machine. The ultimate zip around the corner for mom's cooking machine. And even the ultimate we couldn't get out of there any faster machine. Because at BMW, we know every holiday looks different. So we created the ultimate whatever your road home looks like machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
All the kisses that led to this one. Celebrate every kiss with Kay.
You're ready to start your own business. LegalZoom can help you set it up. We've helped launch and support millions of small businesses. It's kind of our thing. Start an LLC, corporation, or nonprofit with LegalZoom. Let's make it official.
Ow!
So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy. He does exist!
They do exist. Santa?
USAA is made for the safe pilots. For Mac, who can come to a stop with barely a bottle. Lucia, who announces her intentions even if no one's there. And Sergeant Moore, who leaves room for her room. With USAA Safe Pilot, when you drive safe, you can save up to 30% on your auto insurance. Get a quote and start saving. USAA. What you're made of, we're made for.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
Undefeated Terrence Crawford will face Sean Porter.
They say I walk like a king, talk like a king. The thing got was running through these veins, make way for the king.
Welcome to a new time, anyone's time.
Bill Murphy here in studio. Coming up on the Peloton Halftime Report, Trevor Maddich and I have highlights of Central Michigan Ball State. We talk about yet another Power 5 head coaching opening, and Trevor breaks down Michigan State's avenue to an upset this weekend. John, Cole, we'll see you at the half.
All right, Phil, Trevor, looking forward to it. John Schriffen alongside my partner, Cole Kublik. It is a fantastic ball game we have seen. Both defenses have been coming up big, but for Buffalo, their offense, three drives, 183 yards, 10 points on the board.
Really did a nice job of mixing it up the entire game, but especially on that particular drive, being able to find space, create space, and force that defense to play straight up.
This ball is booted into the end zone, so Northern Illinois will come back out on the field. But that last drive for Buffalo, it was impressive.
We discussed mixing it up. Well, you start with an outside zone play, show the end around, keep it, pick up first down yardage. You don't like the way the defense is respecting the end around? All right, give it. Get a nice block up front from Kevin Marks, and then give it to your big boy. Fly over the top for a touchdown. McDuffie in for the first score of the game.
When we talked to head coach Maurice Linguist, he said, we feel like we're going to be able to run the ball tonight.
I think he felt like they had to. And they proved tonight they've committed to it. And they've been successful so far.
Under 5:30 to play. Here's an end around. Trayvon Rudolph in space. It is a track meet. And no one's going to get him. Touchdown, 75 yards. This is the Maction we've been waiting for.
You've been asking for it all night, John. There's your Maction. And what a run by one of the most explosive players in this conference. But watch the block from 25. Clint Radkovcic didn't really get a good shot of it there, but opens up, creates the space. And if you can give Trayvon Rudolph a little bit, he's going to take a lot. Radkovic out front with an excellent block.
extra point is up and good. We are all tied up at 10 apiece here in Buffalo.
Take another look. Nice little motion from 25 as he goes in and comes back out. There he is, bottom of your screen. Radkovich.
Time out on the field.
Driving to the sideline. What do you get from that? Six to the house.
You're a fan. Lucky for you, nothing keeps you connected like AT&T 5G.
5G, huh? Is that fast?
Oh, yeah, it's fast.
And is it reliable?
Definitely is.
What about secure?
Oh, yeah, it's secure.
Love it.
How many of those you got?
I don't know.
You're very good at whatever this is.
You flatter me.
It's not complicated. AT&T 5G is fast, reliable, and secure.
If Philly Garcia didn't have the fighting spirit to drive his ambition, he never would have left home for L.A. with only his car to sleep in. If he listened to those who rejected him, he never would have sold that car to pay for his dream. And if he lacked the will to improve his craft, he never would have made a name for himself, lining up some of the biggest names in pro sports. That's the fighting spirit. That's what makes a lion. Modelo, root for those with a fighting spirit.
This man is about to buy tires on TireRack.com. Tire Rack is the leading online retailer of tires in North America and a repository of advice and expert reviews. And it's done! All that's left is to arrange for safe, easy installation at one of our independent recommended installers. Right now, you can get this special offer when you buy a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. TireRack.com, the way tire buying should be.
Hey, Rick Ross, is Wingstop worried about the wing shortage?
Nah, we doing thighs.
Introducing Thighs. Crispy, juicy, sauced, and tossed. Huh. Now available at Wingstop.
It starts with a mother's determination to treat her baby's eczema and grows into a family business that helps thousands more. It starts with an Army vet's dream of studying the stars and grows into a new career as an astrophysicist. It starts with an engineer's desire to start over and grows into an award-winning restaurant that creates local jobs. They learn how on YouTube. What will you learn?
Excuse me, is that a plug-in
car? Santa Fe has a plug in it. How does that work exactly, you wonder?
Is that a voiceover?
Well, it works just like a Santa Fe, except it has both electric and gas. Sometimes you don't need the gas at all.
So how's the power?
Oh, yeah. Plenty of power. Especially off the line.
Are you done?
Yep. Uh-huh.
Great.
Well, no. One more thing.
Okay.
Evolve your journey in the first ever Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EV.
All right, Cole, as a former center for Auburn, break down that last 75-yard touchdown
so
run.
So it's just an end around, but they're going to give you a little bit of a different look as far as the motion and how they got to.
She's called for at the 25.
You think college holders on kickoffs close their eyes like we used to do when we were kids when we had to hold the ball for somebody to kick it?
I think they're a little more used to it than we were. All right, let's take a look at this schedule we got coming up for week 12. Louisville taking at Duke. That's Thursday on ESPN. Memphis at Houston. That's going to be a really good game Friday night on ESPN2. The big one, obviously, Michigan State at Ohio State. Saturday noon, ABC. Wake Forest taking on Clemson and Nebraska at Wisconsin.
I think that Wake-Clemson game is really interesting as well. Obviously, DJ Uiagalelei and company have not really been able to get the offense going, but Wake stops about nobody defensively. Now, we know that walk the dog zone read offense that Wake Forest has got going, that Coach Cawthon's put in, super effective. Clemson defense been really good still this year, even with all the injuries. But you look at some of the offenses that they played down the stretch, not super high powered. So I think that's a really intriguing matchup.
Just an 8-yard catch for Bernard Porter. Strong throw by Myers. This one up the middle. Dylan McDuffie. Gain of two. And that'll move the chains.
And that will be a first down.
So Matt Myers getting the start tonight for Kyle Van Treese. Van Treese, he is done for the season with an arm injury. And Myers has been effective. Out of the shotgun, fakes, throws, deep. Keon Williams over his head, incomplete. Jordan Gandy was the man in coverage.
You've seen this offensive staff. Coordinator Shane Montgomery has kind of gone out of his way when he's asked Myers to drop back to have extra protection. You've seen a couple of backs or tight ends that have stayed in on protection. So I want to try to keep him comfortable in that pocket.
Myers, the junior out of West Seneca, New York, just about 25 minutes away from UB Stadium here. So this is a hometown kid.
Northern Illinois showing pressure off the near side, which gives you a lot of room in the slot.
Second down, Myers going to keep it himself. A quarterback run. He gets pounded back to the line of scrimmage. No gain. Lance Devereaux with the hit.
When you have a defense that's adding defenders to the box, and you know they are, you had the outlet right there. The uncovered to the slot. Just turn, check, and throw it. Just spin it out to him quickly. Get it to your playmaker in space. Let him try to create. Was not going to be a lot of room there based on the numbers that you had with that play call.
For Myers, he was the starter for Buffalo a few years ago. He got injured and then lost his job to Van Treese. Now he's got the starting job back. Third and 10 for the Bulls. Myers flushed out of the pocket, running for his life, and he will get dropped for the sack. A loss of five. Jaden Dolphin was the guy to get him down.
Pressure came immediately for the Northern Illinois defense. Watch off the right side of the offensive line. That's a twist, tackle and twist. So D-tackle comes upfield. He's the penetrator. Defensive end loops right back around. Michael Kennedy, five, able to get right upfield and flush Matt Myers outside of the pocket immediately. Just no time to set up.
As we approach 3 minutes to play in this first half, we will see our first punt of the ball game for either team. Jake Baltar punts that one away. A very nice punt. Gets a Buffalo roll. That one is touched, but eventually goes out of bounds. It was Cole Tucker who touched it. A 59-yard punt and a 2-yard loss after Tucker touched it.
Well, I understand that you don't want to let this ball just continue to roll, but if you're going to scoop it, attack it. Go get the football. Didn't really appear as though he had his eyes down on the ball when he thought he was going to reach it, maybe pick it up. This could give us a good look right here. Oh, yeah, those eyes came up. Saw him immediately. It's like playing infield, playing shortstop. Got to see the ball in.
What a top-ranked boxing card we have on. Nope. I was going to hype up the fight coming up on Saturday in Vegas, my hometown, but it's okay. We'll get it in later. First and 10. On the ground is Jay Ducker. Now let's talk a little boxing. We got a top-ranked boxing card Saturday in Las Vegas, fight capital of the world. Main event, 12-round super fight between undefeated WO welterweight champ Terrence Bud Crawford and former two-time welterweight world champion Showtime Sean Porter. Prelims start at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on ESPN2, ESPN Deportes and ESPN Plus, followed by the main card at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific on ESPN Plus, pay-per-view in English and in Spanish. Now to get ESPN Plus, go to ESPNplus.com or download ESPN app. Ducker on the ground, can't get to the edge. Jamarcus Ingram. That is the 6th tackle for loss for this Buffalo defense.
The Buffalo ends have done a nice job setting the edge and forcing some of these perimeter runs from Northern Illinois to have to bounce outside.
Buffalo.
And then just other defenders, other blue hats coming up and attacking the ball. Watch the left side of your screen. It's a really nice job by Tim Terry stepping up, setting the edge, creating some trash. There you see five, look at five playing flat down the line of scrimmage. It's a really nice job there. Coming up from his linebacker spot, taking on a puller, and just no run room for Jay Ducker.
So Buffalo playing the clock game, they will actually call a timeout on defense with 2:15 to play because it's 3rd and 15 for Northern Illinois.
Right, look at these flags down behind the end zone. You just think about trying to get a punt off into that win. There could be a really good chance that you have excellent field position if you can get this third down stop.
Buffalo is out of timeouts. That was their last timeout of the half.
middle of the field has been the go-to choice for Rocky Lombardi in these situations to try to attack.
His big fullback, Ratkovich, is in the backfield. Dangerous play here on 3rd and 15 from their own 2. Lombardi from his end zone, backing up, throwing deep. That ball hung up forever, but Trayvon Rudolph comes down with it. A huge gain on 3rd and 15. They pick up 27.
You saw the frustration from Marcus Fuqua, the safety, and the ball could hang because he knew he had single high. You see right there, single safety back deep. If you're going to split the field like that and it's going to take that long for your safety to roll over, you have time to float that football up a little bit further.
There's the experience by Rocky Lombardi. Now they go to the ground. This is Ducker. A gain of 1.
Minute 52 here. You just wonder, are you going to get to the 2-minute offense? Do you want to try to ramp it up a little bit? Comfortable going to the half with a 10-10 lead or 10-10 tie, excuse me? Doesn't it feel like Northern Illinois is going to push the gas here?
I mean, you said it. They're going into the wind. I mean, this direction has been tough for kickers all night long. 2nd and 9, back to the ground for Northern Illinois. Ducker trying to find a crease. Gain of 3.
That time it was Eric Black, 94, just on the edge. The edge defenders for this Bulls defense is doing a really nice job of not even allowing the perimeter to be sealed where those runs can get north and south outside.
Northern Illinois does have 2 timeouts remaining if they do want to use it. Buffalo out of timeouts for this half. We're under a minute to play here in this first half in Buffalo. 10-10 tie. And you can see Northern Illinois, they are taking their time. Play clock down to 1. Lombardi gets it off. Ducker finds a hole. And he will get a first down up to the 44. That's a gain of 11.
Now you want to step on the gas, try to get another playoff.
Lombardi throwing it deep. This is a dangerous pass. Was intended for Messiah Travis, but Jamarcus Ingram, he probably had the best chance at that ball.
He was in position to make a play on this football, just sort of mistimed when it was going to come down. Got the one-on-one, take the shot, but not sure if the timing on the route by Travis there was off just a little bit. Travis, actually, you give him credit for the deflection there. Man, that's probably, you're right, an interception if he doesn't go up and make a play on that ball.
24 seconds to play here in this first half. 2nd and 10 for Northern Illinois. Lombardi pressured, throwing outside. Strong throw. That's to Cole Tucker.
Ball.
Ball's out. Buffalo recovers.
Boy, I think it came out again.
Did Northern Illinois get that back? Looks like Clint Ratkovich might have jumped back on top of that ball.
Rolling on the field is will be a 1st and 10 for Northern Illinois. 30-second charge timeout. Northern Illinois, their 2nd of the half.
That's a massive break. Nice catch by Tucker, just trying to get out of bounds. What a swipe by Marcus Fuqua there. I mean, he got that paw right on the ball and then appeared as though King was going to be able to haul it in.
I mean, Isaiah King had the ball, and he was trying to
there
run
it is.
With it.
Scoop on, and he got taken down by his own
fire.
Teammate. Yeah, a pre-Washington came in. I mean, he's trying to recover the fumble, so it's kind of tough to hit the brakes that quickly.
What a wild sequence, but it's going to result that Northern Illinois gets the ball back. Now, a field goal from here would be 59 into the wind. They
yeah,
need
no.
to pick up.
No, that's just not even a. There's not a cheat code on Sega Genesis to make a field goal from that distance.
13 seconds to play. Northern Illinois does have a timeout remaining. Lombardi over the middle. That's Tucker again. They'll be dragged down at the 31 by Washington, and Northern Illinois will take their final timeout of the half.
I think field goal still pretty iffy from here.
30-second charge timeout. Northern Illinois, the third and final timeout of the half.
I mean, Coach Hammock told us he wanted to get to the 20 going this direction. So here's a look at it. It is moving. Now, you do give yourself a chance to throw the ball to the end zone here. Lombardi obviously could get the ball there. So if you wanted to just take a shot to the end zone, that's on the table for Thomas Hammock.
Is 6 seconds enough time to run a quick out and get some more yards?
Possibly. Yeah, you can get the ball out of bounds quickly. I just don't know if you're going to pick up enough yards, John, if you did that, to make a difference in your field goal attempt.
Yeah, it would be a 49-yard field goal from here. That's why the kicker is going to stay on the sideline. Offense remains on the field for Northern Illinois.
We set the game clock to 7 seconds. 7 seconds, please.
Well, now the entire playbook opens.
Let's see what the Huskies do here with 7 seconds to play here remaining this first half. No timeouts. Five wide receivers bunched at the bottom of your screen. There's the quick pass to Tucker, but he stays in bounds, and that's how the half is going to end.
This is the end of the second quarter.
Now, Northern Illinois will receive the second half kick as we go into the half, all tied up at 10 apiece here in Buffalo.
Nice open field tackle, being able to work through a block from Sean Dolak. Just kind of an odd call there, John, going that quick screen. Not sure if you wanted to get out of bounds or if you're actually trying to make a play.
We're all tied up at 10 apiece here in Buffalo. Now let's send you to the studio with Phil Murphy and Trevor Maddich.
Thanks, John. Welcome in to the Peloton Halftime Report. Phil Murphy here in your college football studios. Northern Illinois, 6-1 score games already this season. Looks like they could well be on their way to another. It is a close game. It's a windy day in Western New York, which means there's incentive to run the football. And Trevor Maddich is standing by to talk a little bit about some of the running game we've seen thus far. Trev.
Well, Phil, the key to the second half is how well Buffalo quarterback Matt Myers can run the read option. This is their best play of the first half on the ground. Now, he's going to read this guy. And when he sees him come inside, what Myers will do is pull the ball from the running back and run where that guy used to be. Now the fullback will also bypass him and head downfield. So keep your eyes on what this defensive end does, because that is the key. They don't have to block him. Now he's not wrong, it's just that they see where he goes and they go into another spot. And what it amounts to is that he can't make the tackle because he was out of position. That means the fullback can go downfield and get an extra block. That leads to a 24-yard run, and I expect Buffalo to be doing this a lot in the second half. The key for Northern Illinois is, will they deal with it better than they just did?
Well, that's what we're watching in Buffalo. Trevor, over in Muncie, Indiana, Central Michigan trying to keep a little bit of heat under NIU to clinch that West Division. Ja'Cory Sullivan to Daniel Richardson. He has one game this season without a touchdown catch.
I tell you what, Richardson has such a big arm.
And here is Khalil Pimpleton, appropriately on a pop pass, reverse.
Listen, you got to know where Pimpleton is. This guy has got All-American written all over him.
Second quarter, 6 minutes to go, 21-10, Central Michigan, but only temporarily. Lou Nichols, already a short touchdown, make it two for Lou.
That's a problem for Ball State because they need another win in order to get bowl eligible, much less win the division.
Final seconds of the first half. Central Michigan leads by 11 over on ESPNU. Coming up after the break, we look at the college football playoff, unchanged top seven. Get Trevor's thoughts on that and look ahead to the college football weekend on the Peloton Halftime Report.
This halftime report is presented by Peloton. Get the original bike, still at the best price ever.
I always start with the Eckrich Deli Meat. It's just a matter of how much I can get in there. And that's how I do Eckrich. And this is how I do Arm Day. I'm getting a crazy pump right now. Oh, 1,001, 1,002.
deodorant keep you fresh all day? We put Dove Men deodorant to the test with Nelson, a volunteer that puts care into everything he does.
It really protects my skin. It's comfortable and lasts a long time.
Dove Men, 48-hour freshness with triple action moisturizers.
Welcome to Allstate, where we have all new lower auto rates. And savings like that will make everyone feel like an MVP. Now get new lower auto rates with Allstate. Because better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate. Click or call for a lower auto rate today.
$5 for the best kind of wings paired with the best kind of celery sticks. Crinkle fries.
Arby's, we have the meat.
Socks are the number one most requested item in homeless shelters. Underwear is number two. T-shirts are number three. That's why we make the most giftable socks, underwear, and T-shirts. And donate one for every one you buy. Bombas.
At the University at Buffalo, it starts with people. People full of passion, tenacity, and purpose. In a place where talent comes together, where ambition inspires action, and our differences make us stronger. Here's where big ideas are born. Success is celebrated. Lives are transformed. In Buffalo, we're excited for a challenge and confident that our best is yet to come.
Welcome to the lifestyles of the smart and savvy. When it comes to saving money, the Marshalls are masterful. But back in the day, that was not the case. Today, savings is what drives them. That's why they chose Consumer Cellular.
You live and learn.
They get the same premium coverage as the nation's leading carriers for half the cost. Imagine talk, text, and data starting at $20 a month. Plus, AARP members get exclusive discounts. Switch today and get $100.
Nice Oakleys, Stipe. Where'd you get them?
GovX.com.
Hey, Stipe, nice boots. Where'd you get those?
GovX.com. Use it. Exclusive deals for first responders, military, and law enforcement only at GovX.com.
Are you wasting money on a timeshare? Cancel it with Titan Exit Group. Get a free consultation and see how they can stop the never-ending maintenance fees and mortgage payments. 100% guaranteed. Call now for your free consultation at 800-211-5779.
Welcome back to the Peloton Halftime Report.
This is the Peloton Halftime Report. Phil Murphy and Trevor Maddich here in studio. Allow us to cycle through the top four of the latest college football playoff rankings. Trevor, Georgia, number one, top scoring defense in the land as well.
They're the only truly complete team right now that's dominant on both sides of the ball. And so far, they haven't even been tested.
Number two, Alabama, easily dispatched of New Mexico State last week. 51-point favorites. No surprise, the Crimson Tide stay firm.
Yeah, and Alabama is competitive with Georgia if they're consistent. They haven't been consistent this year. Against LSU, they only ran the ball for 6 yards, for goodness sake. They need to pick that up.
At number three, Oregon took firm grasp on the Pac-12 North by beating Washington State last week. The Ducks, though, underdogs this week.
And the Ducks are a downhill smash-mouth team. Quarterback Anthony Brown is running the ball as well as any quarterback in the country. Utah is in for a physical fight.
At number four, Ohio State avoided the upset alert last week against Purdue in Columbus. Buckeyes round out our top quartet.
Phil, along with Alabama, Ohio State is the one that's the most dangerous for Georgia, especially on offense, because they are very balanced and very explosive on offense.
As we take a look at the rest of the top 10, Notre Dame yet again moves up one spot, creeping ahead, which only helps Cincinnati's resume. Trevor, any issues you see there, perhaps two teams from the mitten?
Well, if I'm Cincinnati, I'm sweating a little bit more because the committee there has Michigan ahead of Michigan State, even though they have the same record, and Michigan State beat Michigan. That head-to-head only matters as a tiebreaker at the far end of the process. If the committee thinks Notre Dame at the end of the season is definitely better than Cincinnati, they might not even factor in head-to-head because they're not right now.
And for Michigan State alone, there is a measure of consolation in that head-to-head because if Michigan State wins out, they will represent the Big Ten in the Big Ten championship game. But that is a big if because they head to Columbus this weekend and they are getting 19 points.
The reason is that Ohio State has the best group of wide receivers in the country and one of the most explosive passing games led by Heisman candidate and quarterback C.J. Stroud, while Michigan State has the worst passing defense in all of college football.
And if we're having this conversation next week about the whole 6v7 thing or Michigan State being behind Michigan with a win over Ohio State, I'm just going to email our bosses and say, I don't understand college football enough to do this. But to do that first, the big task at hand for Michigan State is beating Ohio State. How do they do it?
Well, they've got to do it with another Heisman-caliber performance by their running back, Kenneth Walker III. And when you watch him on tape, Phil, two things stand out. One is how hilarious it is to watch him make people miss. And the other is how much pride his teammates take in blocking for a Heisman candidate. This is Kevin Jarvis, the guard playing tackle. He'll help to dump this defensive end. Then there's the linebacker there, so he just goes on up and chips a safety. So now, Walker's in the open field where he's hard to touch. Now, will this guy get a hand on him? Just one hand? Won't touch him. Now, they will eventually catch him. But watch how receiver Jalen Naylor finishes the play at the whistle. That's taking pride in blocking for Kenneth Walker III. Now that was at the point of attack. The point of attack here is straight up the middle, and it gets stuck. But even so, the guys on the left are blocking as fanatically as if the play were originally called out there, because they know with Walker, they could end up at the point of attack. That's Connor Hayward and Jalen Naylor out there blocking like crazy. And then I love this one, Phil. This is fun.
And this is the clinching touchdown, too. This is not immaterial.
And he makes that guy miss, but another look shows how he broke out. A.J. Arcuri tackle pulls inside, smashes the nose guard. That's called a wham, and that's to make that nose guard know he's not safe from any position. It's an attitude play, and that's what springs Walker into the open field to make this poor safety, bless his heart, miss in front of the entire nation. This is what Michigan State will need, because they'll give up a lot of points, and Walker will have to help them score a lot of points.
All eyes are on the Buckeye State this weekend, not just because of this massive game on ABC at noon, but also Cincinnati gets something of a test. An SMU squad who's righted the ship after two losses. They're 8-2. What do the Bearcats need to do to keep their positive momentum going?
I thought that they needed style points. They haven't gotten any in the last four games. But what they need to do for this game is just win, and that means their defense has to play at a high level. The offense for Cincinnati has been hit and miss. They've taken entire quarters and even entire halves off over the course of the last month, and it's their defense that has kept them in and helped them to go undefeated during that stretch. SMU has one of the highest scoring offenses in college football. But the Mustangs' defense gives up a lot of points. So this one will be about the defense for Cincinnati holding firm and for the offense to play four full quarters.
Cincinnati 12-point favorites there. All eyes, though, currently on Indiana and Illinois for some action. It's run, run, Rudolph, 75 yards to the crib. Peloton Halftime Report. We'll be right back.
Twas the holiday season and joy filled the town, except for Scrooge. With his perma-frown. The gift of a Peloton bike did touch his soul. Riding fast, flowing proud, getting hella swole.
You can do it!
I'm doing it!
Was Scrooge a new man?
Yes!
Oh, without doubt. When your workout's a joy, it's a joy to work out.
You got her the perfect gift. Does it matter if you give her the perfect batteries? Well, does it matter you arranged for the perfect camping trip but bought the cut-rate bug spray? Does it matter you splurged on the recital dress but got her a budget haircut? Does it matter you organized the dream birthday party but rented a knockoff bouncy house?
It matters.
When it matters that it's Duracell.
Mount Everest, the tallest mountain on the face of the earth.
Keep dreaming.
You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. But you must try, try and try.
उसने जिंदगी भरी बचत करे को इतने लगी हो?
यार उसने लगनी दोनों बच्चों.
You succeed at last.
Stop waiting. Start investing. E-Trade.
Domino's new oven-baked dips are so new that we made a new commercial about their newness. Try new flavors like our cheesy marinara, baked apple, or hot and melty five cheese with our not new but still delicious twists. Carry out Domino's new oven-baked dips and twist combos or any three-topping pizzas for $7.99 each.
Ow!
So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy. He does exist!
They do exist. Oh.
Santa?
Yeah, I got you. Don't worry.
I've started guidance.
Looks like you're home.
This holiday season, hurry in to the BMW Road Home sales event and find your way home in the ultimate driving machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
Ho, ho, ho. Breaking news from the North Pole. The Immaculate Mac is back to pack your TV set with gridiron games. Every Tuesday and Wednesday, to be exact. Catch your favorite team take a snap or intercept a bad pass. High-stepping inside the sideline, striving to put six on the board before the clock hits zero. Ooh, I know that hurt. But what's more appealing than watching your arch nemesis get sacked from the comfort of your couch? This is football fever at its finest. 7 days per week. Christmas just came early.
Explore your passions. Turn dreams into realities. Get involved, connected. Bring your ideas, innovations, and artistry to life, where your education is affordable, where you can make a difference, where you are welcomed, inspired, and challenged, where you can be a Husky. It all begins with a visit to NIU.
This halftime report is presented by Peloton. Get the original bike, still at the best price ever.
Phil Murphy and Trevor Maddich here. Justin Fuente out. Trevor, he's gone after six seasons in Blacksburg.
I think Blacksburg fans, Hokie fans, want to see Shane Beamer come over from South Carolina. He is the son of Frank Beamer, their longtime coach. But I think Shane is happy in Columbia, and I think they're going to have to look elsewhere.
One of a number of notable FCS coaching vacancies around the land.
There are. And LSU is kind of crazy because each of the last three head coaches there all won the national championship, and that would be an incredibly attractive job just because of that.
This has been the Peloton Halftime Report. Enjoy the second half.
Tossed.
Buffalo.
Sauced.
Hot honey.
Flipped.
Boneless.
Dipped.
Arby's.
Razzled.
Buffalo.
Dazzled.
Hot honey.
$5 boneless wings and crinkle fries deal. Arby's, we have the meat.
This is the dimension of imagination.
When I look at my ring, I see the moment that he incorporated my dad.
He was there with us because the letter was in my pocket, right next to the ring.
Mr. Cuesta, let me start by saying that you certainly left a mark on this earth. May I marry your daughter? It is more than a ring. It's love.
Express your extraordinary love. Save 20% store-wide. Jared, love brilliantly.
Three roommates, two packs of Ben's Original Jasmine Rice, one, two, three social feeds, three real-life BFFs. We're all original recipes.
Shh, you think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX 350.
You have three burgers. You sharing, you eating all three?
No, I'm eating them all.
You wouldn't share your burger with me?
Not this burger. The burgers you make at your house? Yeah, we could share that. That's no problem. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger.
What if I'm hungry?
Absolutely not.
celebrating the 25th annual Rocket Mortgage Mac Football Championship. Saturday, December 4th, will be an opportunity to see some of the brightest stars the Mac has to offer and commemorate the conclusion of the 75th Mid-American Conference football season. Make your way to FordField.com/MAC to grab your tickets now. It's time to get some action.
Hinge is the dating app that's designed to be deleted. So meet someone worth meeting and get rid of us. We wouldn't want it any other way.
At DirecTV, we tackle Sundays. We serve up endless expanded coverage. We have the most live sports in 4K, and you can watch anytime, anywhere. We knock out the competition.
Oh my goodness!
Go ahead. Try and catch us. The number one undisputed leader in sports.
Yeah, baby!
DirecTV. We do sports.
You know I got it too. All I'm asking for.
Excuse me, ma'am. Would you like to have my seat?
R-E-S-P-C-T. Find out what it means to me.
A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Welcome back to College Football Primetime, presented by Ram Trucks. It is midweek action here in Buffalo. So much on the line for both these squads. We are all tied up at 10 apiece at the half between Northern Illinois and Buffalo. What's up, everybody? Welcome back inside the booth with my partner, former center for Auburn. He's Cole Kubelik. I'm John Trippin. All right, so it was a clean first half in terms of no accepted penalties, no turnovers, but it feels like Buffalo outplayed Northern Illinois, but here we are, tied at 10.
I don't think there's any doubt. I think Northern Illinois fortunate to be in this football game. A lot of mistakes that they made in the first half, mainly drops. Rocky Lombardi was on target. Looked like he was going to be able to create some things through the air. Multiple times his receivers let him down in the first half of this game. Not just short passes over the middle of the field. There were some others down the field that weren't able to be brought in, but touchdowns did come a little bit later in the first half. Head over the top and then head on that reverse by Trayvon Rudolph for the one explosive play that Northern Illinois has been able to generate here in the first half.
Now, Northern Illinois won the toss and deferred, so they will get the ball first here to start this second half as the wind. I mean, the wind's been the story as well. We've seen them blown off the tee twice already. It's caused havoc with the field goal kickers.
We saw one field goal come up short. Looked like it was going to have enough distance, and that thing just ran into a wall right before it got to the crossbar.
So Alex McNulty boots this one away. You see how the wind just kind of holds it up there. Fielded at the 20, returned to the 35. So good field position to start this second half for Northern Illinois. Let's take a look at our first half stats.
John, you brought it up. No penalties. Nobody's turned the football over. The rush yards for Buffalo, I don't think that really tells the story there, because they had it going early. The ground game was there off the bat. I think that opened up some things through play action. And Northern Illinois, even though has outgained Buffalo, most of that coming on the one explosive play late in the first half.
Rocky Lombardi working out of the shotgun. Here's Ducker. He finds a crease, will slide down, but we got a couple penalty flags down.
Offense, number 69, 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
That's the right tackle, Nolan Potter.
Trying to run outside zone to his side. So we'll take another look here. Top of your screen, 69 on the reach block. Got him reached. Now just have to allow that defender to disengage and pursue the football.
That is
that's tough, too, because Potter hadn't reached. I mean, you got position. You could almost finish that block with no hands. Just body him up. Let your back make the move around the edge.
The first accepted penalty of the game will back up Northern Illinois 10 yards. So first and 20 from their own 25. Lombardi, empty backfield, throw across the field, was looking for Tucker. Incomplete.
Wondering if Lombardi felt that pressure from Eric Black a little bit earlier. saw 94 just come off the edge and maybe let that ball fly a little bit sooner than he needed to.
We talked about early on this defensive front for Buffalo there without three defensive ends due to injury for this game. Kyler Lang, Taylor Riggins, Max Michel, all out due to injuries. They're piecing together that front line for Buffalo, but they have held up tough so far tonight. Second and 20, almost picked off. Tucker comes away with it. Sean Dolak, gain of 8.
Whether it has been crossers or just sit-down routes in zone coverage, these Northern Illinois wide receivers have done a nice job finding space over the middle of the field. Good protection up front. Lombardi has an idea where to get that football right through the hands.
And Tucker is limping after that play. Well, he will come off hobbling and go to the sideline after making that catch. This Northern Illinois offense is already without Tyrese Ritchie at wide receiver for this game. That's Travis across the formation in motion. Third down. Lombardi into double coverage, incomplete. That was intended for Ture.
Ture almost kind of stutter stepped there, like a little bit uncertain if he's supposed to continue that route up the field or actually come to a complete stop. Just a miscommunication there between wide receiver and quarterback.
This will be the first three and out of the entire ballgame. The Buffalo defense coming up big to start this second half. So punting with the win. Ron Cook on the return. A good return up the middle, but we do have a penalty flag down at the 16. A 51-yard punt and a 21-yard return. Let's await and see what this penalty flag is.
During the kick, holding, receiving team, number 19. Penalty is half the distance to the goal from the end of the kick, first down.
So if you're just joining us, Kyle Van Treese, the normal starter for Buffalo, is out. He injured his arm last week against Miami in the loss. Matt Myers, he's done really well so far getting the start.
Been excellent, and it was his legs early on. This group wanted to establish quarterback runs. Couple of really nice reads. We saw him in some touch yardage situations. Drop that shoulder, put it down and try to pick up some extra yards. And we've seen through his arm, he's been fine throwing the football. He's given this Buffalo offense some balance tonight. I think we've really seen how his previous experience has paid off for what Matt Myers has been able to accomplish in this offense this evening.
Well, he will be tested. This is the worst starting field position for Buffalo's offense today. Quick pass to the outside. Get Gassett with the catch. Gain of 5.
You see nice rhythm. Just come out of that fake. Understand where the coverage is soft and deliberate. Know where you want to get the football. Those are the little things that stick out and say, okay, that's a veteran quarterback. It's a guy who's played the position, understands speed of the game.
So second and medium to the ground. This is McDuffie. And Michael Kennedy has been active. No gain.
Both versus the run and pass. He's been nice in some pass rush situations for the Huskies defense. And obviously right here playing the run as well. Bottom middle of your screen. So just below that defender. You see 5 unblocked, come flat down the line of scrimmage. What they try to do is lock that backside. Tight end's going to stay with the in-man on the line of scrimmage. That gives the quarterback keep a little bit more space. Possibly a misread there by Myers, but you never know if he's just told, go ahead and hand that thing off. It's called run, it's not on him.
For Kennedy, that's his 4th solo tackle of the game. Myers dropping back, incomplete, fired it. Looking at Keon Williams. Well, Jordan Gandy was there with good coverage.
Perfect example there, John, of you don't have to sack the quarterback to affect the passing game. Dent the pocket, force the quarterback to just see some of that pressure around him. And I felt like Matt Meyer's eyes maybe came down a little bit because of the pressure around him. Probably forced him to throw that football a little bit early and off target.
Well, how about this? Both offenses moved the ball well in that first half. Now we're seeing them trade three and outs as Buffalo will punt this one away. A low kick end over end will take a Buffalo roll and we'll back up to the 49, a punt of 38 yards. We will step aside, all tied up at 10 apiece here in Buffalo.
Domino's new oven-baked dips are so new that we made a new commercial about their newness. Try new flavors like our cheesy marinara, baked apple, or hot and melty five cheese with our not new but still delicious twists. Carry out Domino's new oven-baked dips and twist combos or any three-topping pizzas for $7.99 each.
Preparation. Commitment. Dedication. These are the characteristics of a champion. So share your tailgates with us throughout the season. America will vote to see if you are the national tailgate champion. Eckridge, you do you.
Espresso Virtuo, redefining coffee with one-touch precision brewing technology. A smooth crema for an exceptional coffee every day. Espresso Virtuo, what coffee is meant to be.
We buy so many different things online, from shoes to socks to shoe socks, baby food, dog food, parrot food, a scarf, the scarf tube, sleeping bag, suit, huh? So why not tires? At TireRack.com, you can find, buy, then have your tires shipped to one of our trusted independent installers for safe, easy installation. Right now, you can get this special offer when you buy a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. TireRack.com, the way tire buying should be.
This is the first photo of your life, son. Your first smile. Your first bath. The room we made for you. And you'll meet Nana and Grandpa. I can't wait for the world to see you. Like I do.
When faced with a challenge, it's good to remember how you've overcome them before. Range Rover Sport, driven to another level.
This holiday season, remember the trick. The one that lets you skip the line and get your finger-licking chicken finger-licking quick.
It's finger-licking quick.
We got a big game buzz.
High stakes, the Spartans and the Buckeyes.
Here's our Week 11 Monday Night Football matchup, a critical one for both teams. Daniel Jones and 3-6 Giants, who should have Saquon Barkley back, basically face a must-win game, while Tom Brady and the Bucs have lost two straight and have seen their NFC South lead shrink to just a game over the Saints. 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and the ESPN app. ESPN2 will have Monday Night Football with Peyton and Eli Manning. Our coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific. Back to live action now. Northern Illinois with a run up the middle. Jay Ducker. We were showing Kenny Galladay. And I got to tell you, I've covered the MAC a lot recently. And Galladay is probably the best receiver I have seen, just pure athleticism, I have seen in the MAC in a while.
Whoa. Okay. Greg Jennings, Corey Davis.
100%.
Antonio Brown.
Corey Davis was phenomenal at Western Michigan. He was more of a route runner. Galladay, just pure athlete. A big run for Ontario Brown, his first touch of the ball game, and he takes it to the house. Coach, give me the rock more. 47-yard touchdown. Northern Illinois takes the lead.
We were talking AB. How about another AB to the house? Thomas Hammack told us that Ontario Brown is our north-south guy. He can definitely get it there, but how about the Jets, too? Running away from defenders. Executed well up front, blocked well up front, but, woo, Ontario Brown comes in. He has two directions on his compass, according to Thomas Hammack. And seeing some of his highlights, I can see why he appreciates that kind of back.
Well, Brown is a guy who lost a lot of playing time after he fumbled in that Bowling Green game. Jay Ducker came on and kind of took his spot. But Brown making a case for why he should get some more touches out there. John Richardson on to attempt the extra point. It is up and good. So Northern Illinois takes a 7-point lead. Touchdown runs of 75 yards, and now this one, 47 yards.
Keep in mind what Thomas Hammack told us. You can go from first to first on our depth chart very quickly because scout team is so competitive. You see there, this just outside zone play with some puller. So a pin and pull scheme trying to get the ball out on the perimeter. Blocked well. Brown, a nice feel for just when to sort of get north and south, when to bounce that thing outside. Shimmy on it, my man.
Nice little dance to celebrate. I like it. This is midweek action. If you can't have fun tonight, I don't know when you're going to have some fun. 7-point lead for Northern Illinois. They need to win tonight to clinch the MAC West. If they don't, they have one more week to do it. But, I mean, we talked about it in the open. You don't want to leave it to another week.
We also talked, John, about teams that just know how to win games, find ways to win games. And you said it coming out of halftime, and I thought it was very accurate. It just feels like Buffalo has outplayed Northern Illinois for the majority of this game, but explosive plays keep you in and help you win games.
Ron Cook lets that ball sail over his head, so Buffalo's offense will come out at the 25-yard line. Went three and out on their first drive. How do they answer here?
Well, you've got to get back to the mixing and matching that you had early in this ball game. Quarterback runs, play actions, RPOs, quick throws. Some of those things have been absent in the last few drives for this Buffalo offense. And I think the confidence of that young man right there, very important. Get Matt Myers back in this football game. Get him believing that he can contribute again.
There's a toss coming across the outside as Gassett. Heavy hitting. We saw some nasty blocks. That was blown up, a loss of two.
We've talked a lot about Dylan McDuffie's prowess carrying the football. How about this block? Watch out in front, right? Yeah! Cartwheel.
This is the first time Northern Illinois has led in this game, so let's see how Matt Myers plays from behind.
Soft coverage up top.
Second and 12 for Buffalo. Good protection, strong throw complete to Dominic Johnson. Gain of eight.
Those are the throws that I think Matt Myers needs to sort of get him tuned back into this football game. Add a couple of runs here and there, get that confidence up, get you into a third and manageable here. Now, third and four. Playbook's wide open. You have the option for some sort of a quarterback read, maybe an RPO.
You know, name we haven't called out much, Keon Williams, the leading receiver for Buffalo. Cook is the man in the backfield for Myers. On third and four, Cook gets the carry. Trying to bounce it, but tackled by five white shirts. Nick Ratine throws his hand saying, not on me.
Well, Devontae O'Malley makes this play happen. 95, left side of your screen, boom, takes on the puller. Now get upfield. When you have a running back on the perimeter that has to track backwards two, three steps before he attempts to gain yardage, good chance your teammates are going to be over there helping make a play.
Jackson Baltar, low kick once again across the whole entire field. I'm surprised that didn't hit anybody.
We call that one a worm burner, John.
A worm burner? Huh. I'm going to have to figure that one out in the break.
Time out of the field.
You think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX 350.
$5.
for the best kind of wings, paired with the best kind of celery sticks. Crinkle fries. Arby's, we have the meat.
With DirecTV Stream, I can get live TV and on demand together. Watch Serena Williams, Wonder Woman. Serena, Wonder Woman. Serena, Wonder Woman.
You cannot be serious!
Get your TV together with the best of live and on demand. Introducing DirecTV Stream.
It starts with a mother's determination to treat her baby's eczema and grows into a family business that helps thousands more. It starts with an Army vet's dream of studying the stars and grows into a new career as an astrophysicist. It starts with an engineer's desire to start over and grows into an award-winning restaurant that creates local jobs. They learned how on YouTube. What will you learn?
This is no ordinary man. He saved money on auto insurance without sacrificing quality.
What's with Dad? Let him have this.
Switch to Amica, a company known for superhuman service and coverage. Get your quote today.
Ow!
So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy. He does exist!
They do exist. Oh.
Santa?
I remember the extra ranch.
Good. Let everything else go.
What else?
Picking our child up?
Cuckoo, I will be right back.
You know you want that sauced and tossed wing stop. And now try it on crispy thighs.
You think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX 350.
Well, it's been a busy year for first-year head coach Maurice Lewis at Buffalo. He started the year as a Dow Boys defensive back coach, played coach in his last game January 3rd against the Giants. He was hired to be the co-defensive coordinator at Michigan, but when the head coaching job opened up here, he took it on May 8th, 115 days to get his team ready for September 2nd to make his head coaching debut against Wagner. And obviously the record is not what people expect, but he didn't have much. It was a ton of guys when he came here in the transfer portal. He had to move his family all around the country. So when he came to Buffalo, he was still getting his mail forwarded from Dallas and Ann Arbor. You got to credit his wife, Stacy, who really held the family in check and got everything centered at his home. He really credits her for allowing him to make this move and make a smooth transition to living here in Buffalo, the community that he loves right now. Northern Illinois on the ground. This is Ducker. And his wife is also super impressive. She's a Howard Law School graduate. Every stop that Lewis has made as an assistant coach, she's taken it upon herself to pass the bar in that state. She is now barred in six states, as well as Washington, D.C., and she's bar pending now in New York. What an incredible family.
Yeah, the only bars I have in six states are candy bars in six states. Super impressive. He was very impressive to visit with as well. And if you want to know how dialed in college football coaches are, he began talking to us about his neighborhood and how much he loves it and his children. You asked him, yeah, what's the name of the neighborhood? He kind of sat there for a second. He's like, I got no idea. I know where it is, and I know I like the people around us.
On the ground, this is Brown. Another good gain, bouncing it to the outside as a Buffalo player is down. He got back to me. He said they went trick-or-treating in the Spalding Green neighborhood in Clarence, New York.
Did he text you on his way home after we met with him and he saw the sign going into the neighborhood?
Josh Rogers is the man down for Buffalo right now.
Rogers trailing this play from behind. This is your truck play again. Couple pullers. Here comes big 99. Just, man, he hit the turf hard. You get a big body like that, kind of slinging off of a ball carrier, 295 pounds landing right on your side. That's tough.
Here's one more look. Let's see if this is how he got hurt.
Watch that left side just right there. Hit the turf hard. Great pursuit, great effort. And just kind of the way that he comes off the ball carrier, see him land hard there, sort of on the left hip, left abdomen, just that's a heavy blow, especially on artificial turf.
Rodgers is the Texas A&M transfer. Now, they're just getting him back from injury, so they were happy to see him on the field. But when you lose a guy at 6'5", 295 up front, when you already have three guys who are down from that defensive front, this is a huge loss.
You know, Kyler Lang, 4.5 sacks on the year. Taylor Riggins, 4 sacks on the year. They're both out. Riggins, a guy they think will play in the NFL. Max Mitchell's out a little bit. Max Michelle out as well. He's a guy that's contributed, also has 4 sacks. You got a DN that's formerly a defensive tackle in this game. So the depth is very concerning along that position.
Now, it is a good sign to see Rodgers getting up and walking off the field on his own power. How about you kick off week 11, NFL Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern with the Countdown crew on ESPN and the ESPN app. They'll have all the early breaking stories, injury updates, and previews of each game right up until kickoff. Northern Illinois approaching 200 yards rushing on the ground. They're at 197 right now, averaging just under 8 yards per carry. First and 10 from the Buffalo 39. Lombardi looking to throw. He's got a man wide open. Trayvon Rudolph, the former walk-on, now getting his volume up because Tyrese Ritchie is out, a gain of 36.
It's a young man that had 14 catches for 309 yards against Kent State. How he gets this open, I have no idea. Excellent play action from Lombardi, sold the fake, and able to find Rudolph on
ball
that post.
On the ground, Lombardi gets back on top of it. That could have been disaster.
I'm not sure he was ready for that snap, John.
Did his running back run into him? I got to see that again.
Just a lot of confusion, and sometimes you get up, big play, trying to go fast. You want to get up, get another snap as quickly as possible, try to punch it into the end zone.
So Ducker's coming through, but it looked like it just slipped out of his hand.
I think the back may have hit it. I think Jay Ducker's left arm may be up a little bit too high, and as Lombardi tried to pull that ball back, it got bumped.
So it'll back him up to the 7-yard line, second and goal. Ratkovich, he's in there. Touchdown, Northern Illinois.
This Northern Illinois offensive line starting to feel it a little bit. The right side, watch 65, Logan Schernitz, kickout block. Blocking down right there, there he's up top. Opens up a lot of space.
John Richardson boots the extra point through. Northern Illinois has opened up a 14-point lead. We were all tied at 10 apiece at the half, but Northern Illinois taking over on the ground.
Offensive line beginning to feel it. Ground game's getting going, and the Huskies on the board again here in Buffalo.
Hey, buddy. Want me to drive?
Why would I want that?
Everyone says you couldn't handle the curve.
Who says that?
You show Tebow a curve, guy falls apart.
Tebow? The curve? No way.
Literally everyone says that.
They're talking about a different thing.
Okay.
Imagine having the elite performance of Goodyear. Now on your Skechers. Enhance your traction, durability, and stability with Skechers featuring the top-tier performance of premium Goodyear rubber. Get all-season performance with Goodyear and Skechers.
Because you're forever connected by love. Two touching center diamonds, representing the connection you share. Forever connected. The perfect gift to give this holiday. Exclusively at Kay.
Welcome to Allstate, where we have all new lower auto rates.
And savings like that make you feel like you won the whole dang thing. Now get new lower auto rates with Allstate. Because better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate. Click or call for a lower auto rate today.
At Fingerhut, we don't define you by your credit score, so we offer low monthly payments on things you need and brands you trust as you build your credit history with a Fingerhut credit account. You do you at Fingerhut.com.
Fingerhut credit accounts are issued by WebBank under FDIC.
At Skill, innovation has always powered us. And now Skill runs on advanced lithium battery technology, delivering longer runtime, maximum power, and 5-minute recharging. Powering your tools and your tech. Skill, the tools to do the job, the technology to do it better.
The Fletcher family is having a hard time.
Dad!
A really hard time.
Baby, what's the matter?
Ah!
A really, really hard time.
Sorry. The doctor doesn't take your new insurance.
But what's not hard? Using ZocDoc to find a dentist, ophthalmologist, orthopedist, or any ist in your network. Instantly book an in-person or video visit with ZocDoc.
Welcome back to College Football Primetime, presented by Ram Trucks. Northern Illinois has all the momentum here at UB Stadium in Buffalo, scoring 21 unanswered to take a 14-point lead with under 8 minutes to play here in this third quarter.
This Buffalo offense has just stalled out in the second half. Big drive for a couple of reasons. One, you need to keep your defense off the field. And then two, got to try to find some points, at least flip the field.
Richardson kicks that one away, fielded and muffed, but picked back up at the two by Cook. Puts his head down, and Buffalo will have to start inside their own 15.
Feels like a lot of momentum is riding with the Huskies right now.
All right, let's take a look at the college football playoff rankings. Your top 10 as of November 16th. Georgia has looked so good all year. And the big one coming up, Ohio State taking on Michigan State, noon Eastern, on Saturday on ABC.
You know, John, a lot of this is going to work itself out, but one thing I'll say about Georgia, nobody will debate that they are the number one team in the nation, but the thing that doesn't get talked about enough, I think, is their resume. Four wins against teams that have seven wins on the season, five teams that are over 500 that the Bulldogs have knocked off this year, three true road wins, one neutral site win, overall opponent record of 56-44. It is a very impressive resume for the Bulldogs as well. It's not just how they're playing, it's actually who they've done it against.
And in the SEC, every week is a gauntlet. Meyer's strong throw completes it to Williams to start the drive. I mean, really, field goal position has been the story of this second half. Northern Illinois, great field position. Buffalo, not so much. That's Kevin Marks straight ahead. And that'll bring up third and short.
And I think part of that, too, is go back to that wind and what a big portion of the story it has been tonight. Buffalo has had to punt into the wind multiple times, and you just feel like they've tried to keep it low out of the air, out of that wind, and they've come up with short points or short punts both times.
So third and one. First half, we saw Myers take off with his legs a lot. He's going to hand off to Kevin Marks with the carry. Devereaux on the stop there, but Buffalo picks up the first down.
Yeah, Marks has plenty of experience, very reliable. Guy's been MVP of a bowl game in his past. Big to move the chains there, though. Give yourself a first down, another set of downs, sort of reset your playbook.
First and 10, Myers looks like he wants to take off on his own. Short run up the middle. They're going to spot him for a gain of four.
Give that little pump fake there, so it's a read. He'll give you the pump, and he's going to tuck it and try to go. But that's a piece of the offense I kind of felt went away. First three, four drives, we saw Matt Myers do a lot with his legs, and then late in the first half, here in the second half, we just haven't seen it drawn up much.
Maurice Linguist is known as the master recruiter, but he's got both of his quarterbacks coming back next season. Quick pass, finds his running back out of the backfield, Ron Cook.
I like the read. A little pressure coming. Just go ahead and spit it out to your back in the out of the backfield. Let Ron Cook get the ball in space. Obviously takes it over to the sideline, but it's always a situation where you see there's the pressure come. Throw right into the pressure. Get it to your back. Put yourself in a third and short.
So some substitutions on defense for Northern Illinois on third and one. Got the big guys over the nose of the ball now. Handoff is McDuffie, and he is pushed back. He did not get it. Nick Ratine, he's been in there first a couple of times now.
Yeah, he and Devontae O'Malley look like they had penetration here early. It's going to come off the right side of your defensive line. Cut it just a little bit too far back and unable to find extra yardage north and south after that. Huskies defensive line, that's a big stop. A nice job getting that penetration early on.
This game feels completely different. What has switched here in the second half?
Momentum for one. And I think the attitude up front, think about both sides of the line of scrimmage, have been dominated by the Huskies here in the second half. Run game's been going, and there hasn't been much of a run game going for the Buffalo Bulls.
Fair catch is called for Cole Tucker as he comes up limping off the field. Got to check to see if he's going to be okay after calling for that fair catch. All right, here's our College Football Awards Spotlight brought to you by the Home Depot. And it's going to feature John Richards, Northern Illinois kicker, and Jack Klenk, Buffalo offensive lineman. Now, remember, you can tune in for the Home Depot College Football Award Show Thursday, December 9th, 7 p.m. on ESPN.
I don't know if we have a celebration award, but Richardson would be in the mix for that one after that game winner last week against Ball State.
Ducker on the carry. He's going to be stopped for no gain. I mean, when you kick a game winner and you didn't win a game and in one game last season, I think you're allowed to celebrate a little bit.
Well, when you run to the opposing team's bench area and celebrate without any of your teammates around you, and you are a 170-pound kicker, I immediately have an ounce of respect for you. It takes a lot for a kicker to gain my respect, but and I know he was going over to grab that Bronze Dog trophy, which he couldn't locate.
It was a rivalry game.
Couldn't locate the trophy, but I give him credit to just going over there to that sideline because that could have ended poorly.
Under 4 minutes to play here in this third quarter. Lombardi out of the shotgun, throws across the field. Another dropped pass by his Huskies receivers. That's Muhammad Torre. That is five drops now on the night.
Yeah, and that's a tough one to say that Torre just drops this pass. It almost looks like the ball might be a little bit late and looks like he slipped a little bit. Get a better look there. See, look, cleats come out of the ground. So, yeah, you're right. You got to come up with that ball. Felt like maybe it came out a little bit late initially, but that's a catchable football.
So third and long, the fullback Ratkovich in the backfield. Three wide receivers set. Lombardi pressured, ball is out. Who's going to get it? And Buffalo has recovered the fumble. Eric Black comes away with it. Huge turnover.
Rolling on the field is a fumble. Recovered by the defense. First down.
All right, so let's watch the pass rush off of the right tackle, right side of your screen, upfield, and then go to that little dip and rip. The hips open up a little bit too early for Nolan Potter, and that allows the pass rush from C.J. Bazile. Right there, you see dip, rip, get upfield. Potter's got to keep those hips square to the line of scrimmage a little bit longer, gain a little bit of extra depth with his pass set. Oh, we're going to crown him. If you're going to crown him, then crown him.
Gets the strip sack and the recovery. Now here's McDuffie, still on his feet, finally brought down by Northern Illinois. A gain of five. Well, that's just the first turnover of the game. Let's see if Buffalo can convert that into points.
Have to. I love the sideline gimmicks. I love them. My favorite is in your hometown.
Second and four. This is Cook up the middle. Touchdown, Buffalo. Coming off of the turnover, the Bulls get right back in the ball game. Twenty-two-yard run up the middle.
It looks like just a little zone cut for Ron Cook. Zone to the right, but he understands that thing's going to bend back quickly. And a really nice job just getting north and south.
Alex McNulty on to attempt the extra point. It is good, but we do have a penalty flag. Looks like it's going to be offsides against Northern Illinois.
Offside. Defense, number 38. The penalty is declined. Try is good.
Just 31 seconds after the turnover, Buffalo cashes in and puts 7 on the board.
You talk about swinging momentum, and it has just all felt like it's been on the Husky sideline here in the second half. Strip sack, recover the fumble, punch it in on a 22-yard touchdown, the next play from scrimmage, and hello, Buffalo, you're right back in this football game.
Well, let's take a look at some of the defensive plays for this Bulls defense. Eric Black got that last strip sack, but there's been a lot of guys getting in on the action.
A lot of penetration from a group that has had to play chess a little bit. Musical chairs along this defensive line with a couple different bodies out, have guys playing out of place, but they have been ferocious for the majority of this game. And when that defense has come up with a big play, it has usually been on the shoulders of this Buffalo defensive line.
So another squib kick fielded at the 20. And here's the problem with the squib kick. You give Northern Illinois great field position after you put 7 on the board, a 20-yard return.
I think you might give them better field position if you try to get it into the air, into this wind, because the flags have not died down at all, really, at any portion of the stadium. And we've seen balls that have been put up into that wind, what they've done. Just completely died. I mean, the life comes right out of any kick that we've seen try to go up against these gusts immediately.
Well, looking at that Buffalo sideline, they are back in this game. They've got energy once again. Just a 7-point ball game. Lombardi hands it off. This is Ontario Brown. And after Brown ripped off that huge touchdown run, coach is rewarding him. He's getting more carries now.
As he should. And we've mentioned it with Thomas Hammack, Northern Illinois head coach, that he's not afraid to take a guy that might not have been running first team all week and give him those opportunities. And as a former running back, he understands probably the momentum and the feel that comes with that position.
Coach Hammack was a running back at Northern Illinois. He coached the running backs in the NFL. And here's some penalty flags before the snap.
False start. Offense, number 79. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
He also mentioned multiple backs for Thomas Hammack. And one thing that I remembered previously visiting with him a couple of years ago was he talked about the weather late in the season for MAC teams. And he told us, I got to build an all-weather team. And we always think about Maxson throwing it around, quarterbacks, wide receivers, a lot of points. But he said, if you don't have multiple backs, tight ends, fullbacks, other big bodies, you're going to find ways to lose games late in the season playing where we play some of these games.
Lombardi throwing into traffic. That's complete to Tucker. The only thing that stood out with our conversation with Coach Hammack is that they took their lumps last year. He played a lot of young guys, got some experience, and now it's paying off for this team.
It really almost feels like last season acted as this team's spring ball, because the fundamental work just wasn't going to be there. The time to develop players last fall was not going to be there. But the experience that they gained and some of the wherewithal is turning into wins this season.
Third and 6 for the Huskies. Lombardi pressured again. He had to get it off quicker than when he wanted to. Incomplete. Was intended for Ture. Good coverage by Jamarcus Ingram.
And that's Damon Williams again, 95. We've seen him move all around this defensive line. Middle of your screen right there. That's just utilizing the hands, a little late rip, winning a one-on-one, against left guard J.J. Lippi. If you can get interior defenders that win one-on-ones, it changes everything, especially with how the quick game has developed through the air.
Cook set to return the punt, and that one will go into the end zone. So a 56-yard punt, but a net of just 36 yards, and this Buffalo offense will come back on the field. Northern Illinois had scored 21 unanswered. We have a turnover, they score a touchdown, and now Buffalo seems like they have the momentum.
And you have to build on it. You have to find a way to take previous success, build on it again. This will be your last possession going against the wind. Probably be able to get with the wind at some point in this possession if you want to, with just a minute 21 left in the third quarter.
So first and 10 from their own 20 for Buffalo. Myers, they fake the end around, and that play is just blown up by James Ester.
Ruling on the field as the runner was down prior to the ball coming out, second down.
Derek Jackson, the Northern Illinois defensive coordinator, told us that, number one, James Ester, he said he needs to be dominant in this game because they felt like Buffalo was a little bit young at center and there were some areas on the interior of that offensive line that they could take advantage of, and said that at 6'3", 286, he's very active. He's a body that can get behind the line of scrimmage, cause some problems. Seen him do it a couple times tonight.
A loss of five on first down brings up second and 15. Back to the ground, one cut, breaking a shoestring tackle. Dylan McDuffie showing the moves. That's why he's the number one running back for this Bulls offense, a gain of 19.
I had a chance to talk to former Buffalo coach Lance Leipold on my radio show earlier this week, and I asked him, I said, Coach, give me just one story on a guy that's still there that you think about that you like, and he said, well, I'll just tell you, the first one that comes to mind is Dylan McDuffie. He told us how excited he was to see his success, how cool it is to see as a young man that started and really has just had a long journey in this program, has had some other players in front of him, has had other guys maybe beat him out, but now ending his career on a very high note tonight on senior night.
Clock winding down on the quarter, 8 seconds of play. McDuffie up the middle, and that'll be the last play of the quarter. Here we go, fourth quarter. Northern Illinois needs to win to clinch the MAC West. Buffalo, they need to win to keep their season alive and try to get 6 wins to become bowl eligible. Who's gonna give? Fourth quarter coming up next.
Lava cake.
Other delivery apps add surprise fees.
It's not cheap.
At Domino's, we're giving out surprise freeze instead.
Freeze with an R.
But we're going to let you know ahead of time. Maybe not like this, though. When you order delivery online, you could be surprised with free food, like lava cakes, stuffed cheesy bread, or pizza. Check the Domino's tracker to find out.
Come give you like surprise freeze.
Look at this. Total pros. First round draft pick.
Rookie mistake.
Undraftable.
Wow. Look at this. This looks fabulous. Where's my plate?
Franchise player.
Eckridge, you do you.
Warm feet and cold hands. Find a fine life, baby.
When I listen to my Sonos, I feel everything.
I can't imagine cooking without Sonos in the kitchen.
It literally makes the food taste better.
It does make the food taste better.
She's stirring.
When you hear the crowd, it's infectious. It's like we're at the game.
I was sold with the theater setup because I'm a big movie fan, and right. You want to be able to feel like you're there.
It's just so simple. Helps you stay in the moment.
I get rid of my couch before I get rid of my Sonos.
You got her the perfect gift. Does it matter if you give her the perfect batteries? Well, does it matter you arranged for the perfect camping trip but bought the cut-rate bug spray? Does it matter you splurged on the recital dress but got her a budget haircut? Does it matter you organized the dream birthday party but rented a knockoff bouncy house?
It matters.
When it matters, it matters that it's Duracell.
After the past year-ish, everyone deserves something new. So, AT&T is giving everyone our best deals on every iPhone, including the iPhone 13 Pro with its amazing camera.
Like everyone that worked from home or welcomed a new family member.
They're all the dogs.
Our deals are for everyone.
It's not complicated. AT&T is giving new and existing customers our best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off the Epic iPhone 13 and iPhone 13 Pro.
What's strong with me?
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 With me.
With me!
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
With me!
Me!
Me! With me.
Got you, don't worry.
I've started guidance.
Looks like you're home.
This holiday season, hurry in to the BMW Road Home sales event and find your way home in the ultimate driving machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
Coach Hammett calls his guys the fourth quarter warriors. You see the point differential in the fourth quarter. He said it dates all the way back to training camp. We conditioned our guys every day after practice, brought it back for the bye week. They are ready in the fourth quarter. Buffalo with the ball. Explosive Dylan McDuffie. A gain of 29 yards to start this fourth quarter.
The Dylan McDuffie is conditioned to pick up yards on the ground. Split zone. They get the edge sealed. You see the tight end come back across the line of scrimmage. McDuffie doesn't have to do a lot of work there. That was easy sailing.
Molinich, the lead blocker. As McDuffie, you hear the sound of those pads popping. That's how much this game means to both of these teams.
You mentioned Molinich, 44. If you see him on the field, it's a fullback. You say, oh, yeah, they got an old-school fullback in there. But he plays tight end. Does not look like a tight end, but you saw him there split zone coming across the line of scrimmage. He's turned into a very valuable blocker for this team.
McDuffie again up the middle. He'll be 2 yards short of the first down, third and two. Buffalo using some pace here. McDuffie, a speed burst. There's a first down.
But John, they stole those yards. I mean, that's just it's literal robbery. To be able to hit the tempo that quickly and not allow the Huskies to get set, you stole that first down.
No huddle again. Here's Myers out of the shotgun on first down.
Now see, just the threat of it forces Northern Illinois go ahead and get lined up. Might not be able to make a check or get into a different call because of the threat of going fast.
Keon Williams at the bottom of your screen. That's the leading receiver, but they keep it on the ground. There's McDuffie again.
Yeah, so that split zone where McDuffie is coming to the left is where Molinich will come straight across to the right. And there's another big block at the end of the line of scrimmage from him there. So they want to give just a little bit of that eye candy. A little bit of visual deception with the tight end coming across the line of scrimmage, but the run actually going the opposite direction.
Eight plays this drive, eight runs. When do they take a shot? Here's Myers with time, throwing over the middle, crossing route. That's Cameron Laybourne. Gain of six, then short 2 yards.
Just
third down.
Just a seventh catch on the year for the freshman, but boy, can he go. And that's why he's on the field. He has the threat to take any ball from anywhere on the field of the house. But a nice job sitting in the pocket there by Matt Myers. Let that crosser develop. Put yourself in a nice third down situation.
Looks like we saw Michael Kennedy, the big defensive end for Northern Illinois, limp off the field. He is on the sideline right now. Third and two for Buffalo. High shotgun out of the backfield. That's Ron Cook. He's got daylight. End zone. Touchdown, Buffalo. A 13-yard touchdown pass from Myers to Cook. And just like that, Buffalo, extra point away from tying this game.
You have to watch the slot on the right. You'll see it come back into your screen. Two big blocks right there. I'll call them blocks because they're not really routes. And you deliver the football quickly out to Ron Cook. That's just a way of running toss sweep. There you see the blocks up top. Walling them off. Shield, whatever you want to call it. It's effective.
Big extra point by McNulty. Up and through. And just like that, after the turnover, Buffalo has now scored 14 unanswered, and we've got a tie game. First-year head coach Maurice Lynquist is fired up. He told us, I want to send these seniors off in style. Senior night at Buffalo. Bulls not going down without a fight.
You think she's still awake?
Don't worry.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Get 1.9% APR financing on the 2022 RX 350.
Tossed.
Buffalo.
Sauced.
Hot honey.
Flipped.
Boneless.
Dipped.
Arby's.
Razzled.
Buffalo.
Dazzled.
Hot honey.
$5 boneless wings and crinkle fries deal. Arby's. We have the meat.
Everyone deserves to see their dreams come true. So LegalZoom, the NBA, and the WNBA are introducing Fast Break for Small Business with $6 million in grants and services for the communities who need it the most. Learn more at LegalZoom.com.
Pass the pants. Hand out the hats. Fork over the flannels. Gift the whole gang. And load up on all of the merry you can carry. Only at Duluth Trading.
Hey there, you getting some gas?
I'm just using your squeegee.
Well, no gas, no squeegee.
No gas, no squeegee? Now free squeegee?
Now free squeegee.
Evolve your journey in the first ever Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EV.
Reggie Bush used to eat breakfast somewhere else, but then he tried Wendy's breakfast.
Woo, baby, that's how you crack an egg right there.
He doesn't even watch football anymore.
Did y'all see this croissant? Who saw this croissant?
Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
If you want a great team, you need natural-born leaders, some tough cookies, and a few who'd do anything to win. Find a group like that. You've got one hell of a team.
Before Clear Choice, my dental health was so bad. I would be in a lot of pain. I wasn't able to eat. It was very hard.
Kimberly came to Clear Choice with a bunch of missing teeth, struggling with pain, with dental disease. Clear Choice dental implants solved her dental issues.
I feel so much better. I feel energized to go outside and play with my daughter. I can eat anything, like I don't have to worry. Clear Choice changed my life.
White bread, two scoops of canned fish. And with Instant Karma, it's the best sandwich ever because it's free. When you pay with Credit Karma Money, you could win instant karma only from Credit Karma Money.
Last year, more homes canceled cable TV than ever before. Why? It's just too expensive. For half the price of cable, you can get Fubo TV and watch the live sports and TV you love. Try free at FuboTV.com.
Look at this Buffalo sideline. This is why we love college football. This team coming into the night, 4-6 on the season. But on senior night, they know if they win tonight and win next week, they have a chance to be, they can be bowl eligible. All tied up at 24 apiece here in the fourth quarter. Buffalo boots this into the end zone, and Northern Illinois will come out to the 25. All right, let's recap how we got here, because this has been a fun game. It was tied up at the half, 10-10, because of the huge plunge by Dylan McDuffie. And the answer, Northern Illinois. That was Trayvon Rudolph, 75 yards to the house.
And then this is Ontario Brown's first touch of the game. And he goes, house call. Buffalo would storm back with multiple touchdowns from Ron Cook. And here we are tied at 24.
Lombardi pressured, throwing on the run. He will complete. That's the Trayvon Rudolph. I mean, here we are, the third tie of the ball game. It was tied at 3 apiece, 10 apiece at the half. Northern Illinois looked like they were running away with this game, and now we're tied at 24.
This is a team that knows how to live here, though. This Northern Illinois team, obviously 6 wins this season by one score. They understand how to play in these situations, and the fourth quarter is where they have been most dominant, not only scoring, but also rushing the football.
First and 10. Handoff is to Ducker, and he is upended. Big hit from Buffalo.
Sean Golak has played downhill with authority tonight from his linebacker position. 52 has gotten to the line of scrimmage in a hurry.
Also, Tim Terry.
Terry's been nice as well, setting the edge from his outside linebacker position, coming up, playing the run. There you see Terry force that thing back inside, turn it upfield, let Dolak come up, make the hit.
A loss of 2. That's the 9th tackle for loss on this Buffalo defense. They've been active in the backfield. 2nd and 12. Lombardi keeps it himself, runs left side, still on his feet. He just ate that hit and kept going. A gain of 13. There's a first down.
I don't know if he ate it as much as it was kind of off target a little bit. Didn't look extremely clean. I like the call, though. Just quarterback power. Almost that truck play, but just let the cue run it. Lombardi keeps it. Understand how to get yarded. This is a team. The most rushing yards they have by quarter is 658 in the fourth quarter. Yards per carry, 5.48 in the fourth quarter. Their longest run of the season, 75 yards. Came in the fourth quarter, and the most 20 yard or more runs they have on the season, 7, have all come in the fourth quarter.
Here's Ducker trying to make a cut. Once again, Eric Black. He's the guy who forced the fumble and really got Buffalo back into this game.
This Buffalo defensive line, when they have needed plays, different individuals have been able to step up and make them in the run game, pass rush situations. And you see right there, Damon Williams, 95, checking out of the game. He has been a big piece of that Buffalo defensive line tonight.
2nd and 7 from the Buffalo 44. Another handoff, and Ducker just tripped up by Sean Dolak, or else that would have been a huge game.
Ducker trying to get his 5th straight 100-yard rushing game. Haven't really gotten number 8 going tonight. Well, quarterback re-dive play there, and you mentioned it. If not tripped up, that one could have been a big hitter.
For Dolak, that's his 11th tackle of the ball game. So on 3rd and short, you bring in the big bruiser, fullback Clint Ratkovich in the backfield. Three wide receivers for the Huskies. 3rd and 3. Roll out to the left. Lombardi, that's the play that's been working this drive. That's the 2nd time they've run it. A first down.
It's a really nice job, the awareness to get north and south, because that play designed to go all the way outside to the numbers. But Lombardi sees the space inside and just turns it up. See right there, an excellent block by J.J. Lippe, 79. A little bit of a kick out there is what it turns into when Rocky Lombardi cuts it upfield.
Lombardi is the Michigan State transfer. He's played a lot at Michigan State.
Lombardi lined up top.
Now, Wildcat formation. This is Ratkovich. And that doesn't fool anybody.
Nice penetration off the edge again. Just another spot where Buffalo defensive lineman finds a way to sneak back into the backfield and be problematic.
We approach 8 minutes to play here in this pivotal fourth quarter, all tied up at 24. 2nd and 9. Lombardi running over that left side, and for the 3rd time, Buffalo defense finally figures it out.
A lot of blue hats responsible for this one. Truck play, we've mentioned it a couple of times. It's an outside gap scheme play. Usually principles are, if you're uncovered, you're pulling. But the quarterback's going to keep it, so you actually add a blocker in this play. and the Bulls still don't let it get going.
This is the ninth play upcoming for this drive. They started this drive with a pass, and now we've seen seven straight runs by this Huskies offense. Third and nine. Lombardi, dangerous throw, but that is complete. Messiah Travis with the catch.
Wow, felt like Tim Terry had an opportunity to step in front of this football. You mentioned dangerous throw. A little bit of a wobble. There you see Terry.
Ruling on the field,
felt like he had an opportunity to get it.
First down. That ruling is under further review.
So the question is, did that ball hit the turf?
Wow, looked like his hands just underneath the football in between the turf.
Heck of a catch by Messiah Travis.
Absolutely. Can't really get a definitive look from that angle. That might be our best look here coming up. To me, it appears hands underneath the football. We see a little separation. Does he survive the ground? To me, it would appear that he does.
It was third and nine from the 34. Right now on the field, it was ruled a 10-yard completion. That would be a first down. But now we're trying to see, was it a catch by Travis? So everything you've seen, you think this stands?
I don't feel like you're going to have conclusive video evidence that would show otherwise. Because there you see space between hand under the ball, space between the ball and the grass, turf. And he survives the ground, brings it back to his body, survives the ground. This would be the look where we would be able to say, no, we can definitively say this is not a catch. And I don't think you have that from that angle. You're talking about a ball came out a little bit wobbly, was short, and Messiah Travis had to go get it, get his hands underneath it, change his body to
After
be able to go
review,
and get it.
The ruling on the field stands. Completed catch for a first down.
That is huge. That is a huge play, not only to pick up first down yardage, but to sort of bail your quarterback out there as well with a little bit of a wobbler coming out there. You make that grab and continue this drive.
Well, this is huge also because this Northern Illinois offense is going into the wind here in this fourth quarter. So field goal tries are not really going to cut it. They got to punch this into the end zone.
Which was such an odd decision from Thomas Hammack to defer at the beginning of the game. Buffalo obviously takes the football, and you had the decision on which way to kick and ended up not having the win behind you in the fourth quarter.
Wildcat again, end around. This is a Trayvon Rudolph. He already has a 75-yard touchdown run. You see the speed outrunning defenders, dragged down at the 10. A gain of 14, that's a first down.
I think we saw this earlier in the game, actually went for a touchdown, and what did we see the first time? Yeah, 25, the little spin around again from his H-back position, and there's Clint Radvikich again, just driving another defender all the way out to the sideline. How much value does this young man have to this team? As a blocker, as a guy that can carry the football in short yardage situations, he's lined up at H-back, tailback, fullback. Really does a lot for this Northern Illinois run game and offense in general.
This drive is eating up a lot of clock as well. Lombardi running left side, trying to pick up a block, but he'll be pushed out of bounds. This drive started with 12:22 to play in the fourth quarter, and here we are, 6:17 and counting on the clock.
I asked offensive coordinator Eric Isaac, says, how many runs do you carry as far as concepts? And initially, I don't think he knew that I meant concepts. He meant actual runs. I don't know, 40, 45? I'm just thinking, hold on a second. How can you run 40-some run plays in a season? And he was meaning by formations. But just by concepts, they run almost all of them. But now they have dialed it down to this truck play on this drive and been dominant with that from the quarterback spot.
Second and goal. Lombardi keeps it. And he will be dropped by Josh Rogers. Good to see him back out there. He was shaken up earlier in the game, but back to causing havoc up the middle.
99 and 95. Rogers and Williams inside helping make that stop. So going back to a little bit more of a zone scheme there and allowing the quarterback to continue to just go ahead and carry it. Feels like we want to try to play it pretty safe by allowing Rocky Lombardi to carry the football and add a blocker. I have to come up with something else here. I don't think Q Run can get it done in this spot.
This drive has now eaten up over 7 minutes of clock here in this fourth quarter. Third and goal from the 9. Pressured. Incomplete. Lombardi tried to force it into a window, but Marcus Fuqua, the safety, was on the spot.
Fuqua had this interception. It's there, and it's not a great decision from Rocky Lombardi. You mentioned trying to force it in there. Almost felt like this decision was predetermined, whether he liked the matchup, whether he liked the leverage, the alignment. Felt like he decided he was going to throw this football before it was snapped. And that had every opportunity to be an interception for the Buffalo Bulls.
Richardson attempts the 27-yard field goal. It is up and good. So Northern Illinois retakes the lead by 3. Under 5 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter.
The best things America makes are the things America makes out here. The history she writes in her clear blue skies, the legends she births on hometown fields, and the future she promises. When we made Grand Wagoneer, proudly assembled in America, we knew no object would ever rank with the best things in this country. But we believed we could make something worthy of their spirit.
This holiday season, give your family the gift that keeps on going.
Our very own Energizer Bunny.
Energizer Ultimate Lithium. The number one longest lasting AA battery.
Ow!
So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy. He does exist!
They do exist.
Santa?
Progressive presents At Home with Baker Mayfield.
Really appreciate you stepping into house sit. Everything should be pretty straightforward. Here's the keys. Let me show you inside.
So each heater's on its own power grid, so you're just gonna have to throw the breakers each night.
Tuesday's trash day. Just pull the dumpsters out the night before. Do you like dogs?
There are dogs?
It's a whole section of them. If you're gonna leave, remember to set the alarm. The code is 6.
Just 6?
Shh.
NyQuil Severe gives you powerful relief for your worst cold and flu symptoms. On Sunday night and every night, NyQuil Severe, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head, best sleep with a cold medicine.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Ram Trucks, Motor Trend's Truck of the Year for the third year in a row.
Cool shot of downtown Buffalo looking at the McKinley Monument. 96-foot-tall obelisk in Niagara Square in front of Buffalo City Hall. How about week 12 schedule? Thursday night, Louisville at Duke. Friday night, I really like this one. Memphis at Houston on ESPN2. Then Michigan State, this is the big one, against Ohio State Saturday on ABC. Game day will be there. Kickoff return, big pop on special teams. Buffalo takes it out across the 30. Well, if you're Buffalo, this is what you want, right? Senior day, you need to win. This is your playoff game, and you're only down by 3 with the ball.
And this is the group you want on the field. More veterans on this side of the football, playmakers on this side of the football. You've got the wind at your back, which is a massive benefit for the Bulls here late. 4:54, plenty of time. Don't have to rush anything. Play within your offensive scheme.
Both teams have all their timeouts. McDuffie. Nope, that's the keeper, Matt Myers. We saw him run a lot early in the first quarter, he was effective. They went away from that later on in the game.
See Jake Mullen, it's 44, just laying on another defender there. That's where the split zone can really be beneficial. When he comes across, gets a big block, but Matt Myers keeps the football. So it almost turns into a lead behind a former fullback now playing tight end.
Myers, the junior from West Seneca, New York, just down the road from Buffalo. Pressured, somehow gets away from the rush, throws it away, incomplete. Myers should have been dropped for a loss of about 10. Devontae O'Malley was there.
Well, Shane Montgomery told us, we don't want to leave the right tackle on an island. DeAndre Diorn, right there, you see, beat inside. That's Devontae O'Malley again, 95. Just a nice move. Show some good quickness right off the jump to be able to get into the backfield.
Timeout for an injured player on offense.
So an injury timeout on the field as Myers was down after the play. So they're going to check on the quarterback, Myers. Pivotal drive for the Bulls. Down by three, just over 4 minutes to play.
At Domino's, we're giving away $50 million in surprise frees instead of surprise fees like other delivery apps. When you order delivery online, you could be surprised with free lava cakes, free stuffed cheesy bread, free pizza, or more.
Oh my goodness!
When I look at my ring, I see the moment that he incorporated my dad.
He was there with us because the letter was in my pocket, right next to the ring.
Mr. Cuesta, let me start by saying that you certainly left a mark on this earth. May I marry your daughter? It is more than a ring. It's love.
Express your extraordinary love. Save 20% store-wide. Jared, love brilliantly.
Hey, 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 how you doing, baby? You look mad if I figured I might come your way and roll up on you with that golden ticket. Try to get
smell irresistible. The new Axe Effect.
Ever wanted the sensation like you're floating on air? You can with Skechers' new Glide Step footwear. Feels like you're floating as our Aero Comfort outsoles give you a pillowy soft landing, then propel you forward. Plus, they have Skechers' exclusive air-cooled memory foam. Try Skechers' new Glide Step.
I always start with the Eckrich Deli Meat. It's just a matter of how much I can get in there. And that's how I do Eckrich. And this is how I do Arm Day. I'm getting a crazy pump right now. Oh, 1,001, 1,002.
The ride of your life is closer than you think. For the first time ever, buy your new car entirely from home with Nissan at Home. Delivered direct from dealer to driveway.
Butter pecan.
Buttercream.
Butternut squash.
Butter garlic.
Better not come in here with that noise. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger. Baseball. Butter, 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 butter. Sweet butter. Butter.
We got a big game buzz. High stakes, the Spartans and the Buckeyes.
I sound like a champion.
ESPN, home of the college football playoff.
Run it.
I love that music, getting us hyped here for a big 3rd and 8 for Buffalo. They can't give the ball back to Northern Illinois here. The Huskies just ran their drive, just ran half the court. Here's Myers throwing deep, incomplete. Was looking for Laybourne. But Jordan Gandy with good coverage.
Jordan Gandy right there in phase. Heck of a job by the Buffalo offensive line picking up this pressure. Huskies showing all-out blitz there at the line of scrimmage. Myers gets the ball out quickly. That ball may be a little bit too far inside. Receiver's going to have to try to adjust, but again, good coverage.
So correction, before we went to break, I said it was Myers who was down. It was not the quarterback. It was Gassett, the wide receiver. So Myers stays in the game here. Fourth down, offense on the field on 4th and 8. Myers out of the shotgun. Here comes the blitz, picked up by Northern Illinois. Throwing on the run. What a completion by Myers, finding Dominic Johnson on 4th and 8. They pick up 15.
Delayed pressure comes from the right side of the offensive line. There you see, backer coming to the outside, corner crash as well. Kind of picked up initially, but then Myers just makes a move, gets out, creates some space on his own. Heck of a throw on the move to be able to convert a 4th and long.
To the ground, this is Dylan McDuffie. You get the sense that Matt Myers has kind of been the wild card tonight, getting the start over the injured Kyle Van Trees.
He has shown a lot of poise, a lot of confidence, and it began early with quarterback runs and him either making good decisions by pulling a few ball downs or just called quarterback runs. But here he's made some big throws late in this game.
That's Van Trees. He injured his shoulder. He is done for the season. He does have 1 year remaining of eligibility, so he can come back and play for Buffalo next year. Second and 7. Shotgun, keeper, Myers running left side, sidesteps a man. And we'll get a short gain of 2.
Shane Montgomery taking one from Eric Eidsness, the Northern Illinois offensive coordinator, who we saw on their previous possession just say, you know what, heck with it, we're going to add a blocker and run our quarterback. Outside zone there, let the quarterback keep it. You pick up an extra blocker, just trying to win numbers in the box, pick up a few extra yards. Much better third down situation here for Buffalo than they faced in the previous down.
Under 2.5 to play here in this fourth quarter. 3rd and 4. Buffalo, all 3 timeouts remaining. On the ground, McDuffie somehow finds a crease. I wasn't sure he was going to get through that hole, but he picked up a 1st down, a gain of 10.
Dylan McDuffie spent a lot of time as a backup here in this Buffalo program, and he's proven a lot of folks wrong. Watch 44 again. Jake Mullinitz, big block on the split zone. He opens that up for McDuffie to just drive straight ahead. And then it's just bullying through defenders to pick up yards after contact.
McDuffie stays in the game at running back. He gets the carry here, and he won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Brought down for a loss of 2.
I feel like the last couple plays have essentially told the story of this game. Certain position groups have flashed greatness and then completely disappeared at times. And we see a couple dominant runs from the Buffalo offensive line, and then all of a sudden you get 2-3 Northern Illinois defensive linemen that just bust through right there and grab a tackle for loss.
Staying on the ground, McDuffie. Brought down by Lance DeVoe. A gain of 3. Now the key here is that Buffalo does have the wind at
seconds.
Their back.
Charge timeout. Correction. Full timeout. Buffalo, their first of the half.
So Buffalo takes their first time out of the half. They will have 2 remaining. 1:21 on the clock. 3rd down after the break.
We're getting destroyed out there. We need a plan.
I have a plan. Right now, at T-Mobile, customers on Magenta Max can get the new iPhone 13 Pro, and T-Mobile will pay for it.
It has the most advanced iPhone camera ever.
I'm talking new customers. I'm talking existing customers like Ronald.
The new iPhone on T-Mobile. Let's do it!
New and existing T-Mobile and Sprint customers can upgrade to the iPhone 13 Pro on us on our most popular Max plan.
Do we have a plan for the second half?
Nah, we're going to get creamed.
But we'll be on T-Mobile.
$5. For the best kind of wings, paired with the best kind of celery sticks. Crinkle fries. Arby's, we have the meat.
Welcome to Allstate, where we've just lowered our auto rates. And savings like that follow you everywhere. Now get new lower auto rates with Allstate. Because better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate. Click or call for a lower auto rate today.
Ow! So you think Santa will like these red and green M&Ms?
I don't know. I never met the guy. He does exist!
They do exist.
Santa?
I can feel the warmth. Deep down in my bones. I know that I am home.
I miss him too.
Love brings us here. Together's where we all belong. You're my home.
I'm okay.
My home.
The road home for the holidays, where the ultimate driving machine becomes the ultimate cruise through three states machine. The ultimate zip around the corner for mom's cooking machine. And even the ultimate we couldn't get out of there any faster machine. Because at BMW, we know every holiday looks different. So we created the ultimate whatever your road home looks like machine.
Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
Much time to yourself. So when you do, make it count with Crest Pro Health. It protects the eight areas dentists check for a healthier mouth. The number one toothpaste brand in America, Crest.
So a big third and nine coming up. If Buffalo can't advance the ball, it would be about a 53-yarder from here for McNulty. He's one of two on the night. Now, the one miss he does have was into the wind. He has the wind at his back here as you see the flags blowing.
A lot of it. A lot of wind at his back.
Third and nine for the Bulls offense. Myers on the ground to McDuffie, and he is dropped. DeVoe again.
There's part of me that wonders, late in this play, did Dylan McDuffie feel like he needed to get the ball back to the middle of the field? And by doing so, if that was the case, he cost himself another yard or two on this attempt. Now, did get it to the middle of the field.
Now, McNulty's career long is a 50-yard field goal. It was here against Bowling Green back on October the 30th. From where we stand right now, this is about a 54, 55-yard field goal. This would be a career long for Alex McNulty. Officially, it is a 55-yard field goal attempt. He does have a ton of wind at his back. Down by three. It all comes down to the kicker, Alex McNulty. Snap is clean. Kick is up.
And he got it.
How about it? Alex McNulty. A career-long 55-yard field goal ties his game at 27.
McNulty went bunk. This thing's got plenty of room to spare. Goodness gracious. I don't care how much wind you have at your back. You can't feel comfortable rolling your kicker out there from that distance, but that was absolute money.
Maurice Linguist, his first year at the helm at Buffalo, he says, I knew it all along. His guy, Alex McNulty, just nailed a 55-yarder to tie up this game. My goodness.
Unbelievable. McNulty walking out there with the swag of Omar.
Not only is that a career long for McNulty, that 55-yard field goal is now a Buffalo school record. But there's still a minute 10 on the clock for Northern Illinois, and the Huskies have two timeouts remaining.
You almost have to wonder, is game-winning field goal off the board unless you can get maybe to the 20 or a little bit closer because of the wind? The wind's actually picked up from here in the last 5-6 minutes.
All right, let's take a look at tonight's player spotlight brought to you by Tide, and we're going to spot the light on Eric Black. Came up with the play of the game. Northern Illinois had scored 21 unanswered points, comes up with the strip sack, recovers the fumble, and then Buffalo got back into the game.
This really was a must-have play, a play where all of that momentum at that point in time was with Northern Illinois. You mentioned the amount of points that had been scored and not been answered. That was a must-have in play, and not only did it get the ball back, but then on the next offensive play, the Bulls able to punch it into the end zone.
So here we go. Northern Illinois needs a win tonight to clinch the MAC West. End around to Rudolph. A handoff to Rudolph coming out his wide receiver position. And it gets a gain of four.
30 second, charge timeout. Buffalo, their second of the half.
So Buffalo calls a timeout. 101 to play here in this fourth quarter.
Now, John, I'm not saying you're really pressed for time, but you wonder what kind of opportunity you have at the deep ball because of the wind. And with just over a minute remaining, I mean, you run a jet. I know you're trying to stretch the defense out a little bit. And I actually thought Rudolph may have had a couple opportunities to get that ball north and south earlier than he did. But now you're at a minute one remaining. You do have two timeouts, but you're painted into a corner a little bit with this win from a field goal perspective and with what you might be able to do through the air throwing the football.
Ratkovich, the man in the backfield. He gets the carry. He's got a hole on the right side. Pushes Pyle and gets out of bounds. First down.
This little power play. J.J. Lippe, left guard, 79, is going to pull around, kind of lead the way. One thing you get sometimes with the bigger backs is, yeah, they're a little bit slower, but it almost is built-in patience. You see 79 right there. Excellent job just climbing up. And then Ratkovich just kind of falls behind, drags a little bit. Kind of reminds me of Heath Evans when I was at Auburn. He's a fullback that we moved to tailback, and not being quite as quick or fast as a running back almost was built-in patience.
Under a minute to play. Here's Ratkovich again, like a bowling ball, just bouncing off defenders. You have a flag come in.
Another big block from J.J. Lippe, 79. It's going to be a little bit more of a kickout block this time than it was turning up field.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number one. 15-yard penalty added to the end of the run. First down.
That is a massive, massive mistake. And there it is. It's the right call.
So a gain of 17. You tack on 15. That's 32 yards on that last play for Northern Illinois.
Yeah, Corey Gross Jr. grabbed that face mask, yanked it down. That is a big boost for the Huskies offense.
Under 50 seconds to play. Northern Illinois has two timeouts remaining. Keep it on the ground. Ratkovich putting his hand on his blocker's back.
It's another power play, gap scheme play.
30 second, charge timeout. Northern Illinois, their second of the half.
Liam Sorhan tied in, leading around there. Now Huskies will take another timeout. One timeout remaining for the Huskies. 41 seconds left. Haven't really had to put the ball in the air on this drive. Yes, you're aided by a penalty, but it also feels like Clint Ratkovich has been the answer at running back, just specifically in this drive.
Was it interesting that Buffalo actually called a timeout earlier on this drive?
After
a little head scratching, right?
After a jet that went for what, 3-4 yards? It didn't feel like it made a lot of sense at that moment.
So Northern Illinois with one timeout remaining. From here, this would be about a 40 to 41 yard field goal, but you're looking at a stiff win in your face. Second and five. Another carry. Ratkovich spinning. Will be pulled down at the 21, a gain of 2. Third down. Sean Dolak on the stop.
Close games, not new for this Huskies football team.
Ratkovich chopped down, won't get to the corner. It's Dolak again, bringing up fourth down.
Dolak, the former walk-on linebacker, has just been exceptional today. If he needs to play downhill, he's been able to do that. East-West been able to do that. So active from that linebacker spot. 52 has made a lot of plays tonight.
That was Dolak's 13th tackle of the game, but that was his biggest one.
Northern Illinois, their third and final timeout of the half. Please reset the game clock to 2 seconds. 2 seconds.
So here we go. This would be a 37-yard field goal attempt for John Richardson. Kicked the game winner last week. He's set up to be the hero again tonight.
Now, Thomas Hammack told us he felt like the 25-yard line was where they needed to get to attempt a field goal heading into this win. Obviously, a couple of yards ahead of that, going to have to do it from the hash.
Now, Buffalo missed earlier in the game from 42 yards out going into this win, and the wind just simply knocked it down. Officially, this is a 38-yard field goal attempt, and Buffalo will use their final timeout to try and ice the kicker.
32nd, charge timeout. Buffalo, their third and final timeout of the half.
Last week, we talked about John Richardson being the hero in the win over Ball State. Let's take a look, because this is what Northern Illinois does. Dude, this is what they do. Last second, no problem. Ice in the veins.
I am not one for kicker celebrations, but watching that one live last week was absolutely hilarious. And that was after he ran to the sideline to try to grab the Bronze Stalk Trophy.
Can he do it again? John Richardson from 38 yards. Snap is clean. Kick is up. No good. The wind pushed it. We're going to overtime in Buffalo.
Even though this misses left, the hang time is ridiculous. Look at that thing just die and just float. Oh, man.
With so much on the line, isn't it fitting that this game goes to overtime? Senior night in Buffalo, extra football.
The best things America makes are the things America makes out here. The history she writes in her clear blue skies, the legends she births on hometown fields, and the future she promises. When we made Grand Wagoneer, proudly assembled in America, we knew no object would ever rank with the best things in this country. But we believed we could make something worthy of their spirit.
This is the dimension of imagination.
We buy so many different things online, from shoes to socks to shoe socks, baby food, dog food, parrot food, a scarf, the scarf tube, sleeping bag, suit, huh? So why not tires? At TireRack.com, you can find, buy, then have your tires shipped to one of our trusted independent installers for safe, easy installation. Right now, you can get this special offer when you buy a set of four select Bridgestone tires. For details, go to TireRack.com/Bridgestone offer. TireRack.com, the way tire buying should be.
Mount Everest, the tallest mountain on the face of the earth.
Keep dreaming.
You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. But you must try, try and try.
उसने जिंदगी भरी बचत करे को इसके लगी हो?
यार उसने लगनी गुन्नू बच्चों.
You succeed at last.
Stop waiting. Start investing. E-Trade.
What's strong with me?
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 With me.
With me!
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
What's strong with me?
With me.
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 With me.
Welcome back to Buffalo. We're getting set for overtime.
Yard line. Each team also has one timeout per overtime period. Northern Illinois, you will call tails and heads. What is your call?
Heads.
Heads is called. It is heads. Would you like offense, defense, or direction?
Defense, please.
You want to go on defense. Which end of the field would you like to play? Okay. It'll be Buffalo's ball, first and 10, at this end zone. Good luck.
So Northern Illinois won the toss. They've decided to defend. Buffalo will pick the end of the field. They've decided to go to the end where the wind is at their back.
That's no surprise there. How polite Rocky Lombardi is, though.
That is the important part here, because when you kick into that wind, we haven't seen any of the field goal.
Nobody wants any part of that anymore. We'll get it either way if we have to continue past this overtime, but still.
You know, you look at the rules, each team gets one possession for the opponent's 25-yard line in each overtime through the first two. Then you got to start going for the two-point conversion. I mean, we've had four ties in this ball game. We were knotted up at three after trading field goals, knotted up at 10 at the half. They tied it back up at 24, and here we are, tied at 27, going into overtime as Buffalo will get the ball first.
John, I just wonder, does one of these two teams maybe take a shot at the end zone early in their possession? I don't feel like we've seen a pass thrown more than 10 yards downfield in a quarter and a half.
Two running backs set for Buffalo. McDuffie gets the carry. Largest lead of the ball game was 14 for Northern Illinois. They had scored 21 unanswered in that third quarter. And then they fumbled the ball, let Buffalo get back into this game. That's how we got into overtime. Coach Thomas Hammack did not win a game last year. What a turnaround. He's trying to cap it off with a win tonight, would clinch the MAC West. McDuffie again stood up on that line, gets to the 20-yard line, a gain of four. Jordan Hansen on the stop.
Pretty good penetration up front by that Northern Illinois defensive line. Damon Taylor, number 10, stepping in there, getting a pretty good push. James Esther, number one.
So third and five, you got to think they're throwing here, right?
I wouldn't be surprised with a run, trying to get it to the middle of the field even.
Myers with time, crossing route, that's complete. And that's Keon Williams, Eastern Michigan grad transfer.
That's going to be short.
It is close. Let's see where they spot it.
Ruling on the field is fourth down. Fourth down.
So it is inches away from that first down marker. Offense is still on the field.
Ruling on the field is the runner was short of the line of gain. That ruling is under further review.
So the officials will review the spot on that catch by Keon Williams. Here's a look at it.
Yeah, Matt Myers just going a little crossing route, waits for it to develop. Delivers a pretty good ball. Coverage not bad there from Javon Bird. This will give us a pretty good look at maybe where this ball
has to get to the 20.
Spotted.
It looks like the ball is across the 20.
There's plenty. I think either way, whether you want to talk momentum or not, looks like there was enough yardage to get there to the 15.
Yeah, excuse me. You need to get to the 15. I apologize. I think that's the best look right
there
where he stretches the ball over.
Not really in question. based on that angle. I think you have to, based on that look right there, you have to say that this one is going to be overturned and Buffalo going to be looking at a first down.
After further review, the runner did achieve the line to gain. It'll be first and 10 at the 15-yard line.
So nice job by this officiating crew to get the call correct. New set of downs for Buffalo.
Able to reset things offensively. You got both your tight ends in the game. Trevor Borland, Jake Mullinich, 34-44. Have to think ground and pound, way to go here for the Bulls.
McDuffie in the backfield. He gets the carry, running, trying to get the edge on the right side. Gets across the 10, Devontae O'Malley. Good in there on pursuit, a gain of 7.
Now, one thing Derek Jackson, Huskies defensive coordinator, told us is our defensive ends can be big. Look at the left side of your screen, 95. He bulls through both tight ends and then helps make the tackle, chasing it all the way across the line of scrimmage.
Second and 3. On the ground, spinning, turning, trying to find that first down marker, McDuffie. And he does have a new set of downs, first down for Buffalo.
McDuffie just has so many different ways that he can create extra yardage. You see the spin move there, whether it's bouncing off defenders, getting to the outside, bouncing, showing some speed.
For McDuffie, that was his 28th carry of the night. Here's 29. On first and goal, a gain of 2.
We talked a lot about Matt Myers early in this game and his capabilities to run the football. Have not seen a ton of it since the game has progressed, but he always does have that option to keep, pull it down, and maybe get yardage on his own.
McDuffie straight ahead, trying to push. But he'll be stopped short at the 2. That'll bring up 3rd and goal now. And on this big 3rd down, Buffalo's going to call a timeout to talk things over.
Charge timeout. Buffalo, their only timeout of this overtime period.
So what's this discussion between Maurice Linguist, Shane Montgomery, his offensive coordinator, here on this 3rd down?
I think you just want to get on the same page. You want to have an understanding of what your read is, what your keys are, whatever play it is that you decide to go with, and you think you're right in that two-point play range. So if there are plays that you've been holding, there are plays that you know or you think you're confident could work down in this situation, you talk it over with your guys. If there's going to be a change in alignment, if there's going to be some sort of formation shift, maybe you're going to change the snap count a little bit. You just want a chance to discuss that. Why not use the timeout, discuss it a little bit, build some confidence, have a little bit of a break, try to pound this ball into the end zone and really put the pressure on Northern Illinois.
3rd and goal from the 2. Ball is snapped, fumbled on the ground. And Northern Illinois comes away. DeMond Taylor, are you serious?
Rolling on the field is a fumble recovered by the defense. It'll be Northern Illinois' ball at the 25-yard line.
Oh, it's right in his hands. It's just right in the hands of Myers. I don't know if his eyes come up and he's looking to do something a little bit earlier. That was not what they discussed during the timeout. On that shot, it looks like his eyes come up a little bit before the ball gets there.
So a critical turnover on 3rd and goal. And now, Northern Illinois, a field goal or a touchdown away from clinching the MAC West title. First and 10 from the 25. Clint Ratkovich is in the backfield. He's been so steady here in this fourth quarter. Gets the carry over the right side. He's got daylight. No one's going to touch him. Touchdown, Ratkovich, Northern Illinois. Your MAC West champs.
We've seen this play probably 10 or 15 times in the last two or three drives for Northern Illinois. Power play, left guard going to pull around. 79, J.J. Lippe, another excellent block. And Clint Ratkovich again. Rocky Lombardi's hands went up. He called a shot. He pulled a Lane Kiffin. As soon as Ratkovich got off tackle, he knew it was a touchdown.
This has got to be one of the best turnarounds in MAC football history. Northern Illinois last season didn't win a single game.
Winless.
Now, 8-3 with their sixth win in the conference, they win the MAC West and punch their ticket to the title game.
Let's get another look at the final play. Once again, power off right tackle. There's 79. The reach block, the seal, and then 25, Clint Ratkovich. The short yardage back, according to Thomas Hammock, mind you. The walk-off winner. Great execution, great effort, great run, and a play that that team had been leaning on. Oh, and he got the punt off, too.
Last week, it was John Richardson, the hero. Tonight, Clint Ratkovich, the walk-off touchdown in overtime. The fourth rushing touchdown for Northern Illinois on the night, the second for Ratkovich. How about these late-game heroics for the Huskies?
It's unbelievable. And you think about a team that's still about 80% of this roster is made up of first- and second-year players. To be able to have the maturity, to be able to have the wherewithal, to be able to have the understanding of how to stick in and win games late, to battle back, to continue to scratch and claw, that doesn't just come naturally. And that's why I said earlier in the broadcast that I felt like last season almost acted as a spring practice for this football team. There was a lot of development that just couldn't happen in practice. The separation, having meetings on Zoom, not able to be around each other, not practicing as much. A lot of that time together, a lot of the development, a lot of the work and skill that needed to be trained on had to take place in games. And Coach Hammock even told us that. Said we did a lot of learning in games because we couldn't teach as much as we wanted to. And now you're seeing a lot of those young guys that were just thrown into action last fall where they didn't win a single game pay off for this ball club, not only tonight, but this entire season.
Last week, Northern Illinois head coach Thomas Hammock got a contract extension. Tonight, paying it off with a MAC West title in overtime in walk-off fashion. Clint Ratkovich is the hero. We talked about the fourth quarter Warriors. Now the overtime Warriors. We've got head coach Thomas Hammock with the headset on. Coach, first off, congratulations. You didn't win a game last year. To turn it around and win this MAC West title, describe this feeling.
You know, I'm just proud of our kids. I'm proud of the coaches. They stayed committed. They grinded. Whatever came our way, we just stuck together. And that's a team, a group of men that work together, that compete together, that grind together for one thing, and that's to win. And nobody thought it was possible. People said we was going to finish last. But all I know is this. We are the MAC West champs.
Coach, it felt like Clint Ratkovich sort of, there was a decision late in the fourth quarter for him to become your guy at tailback. Not only does he punch in that game winner, big for you on the last few drives of regulation. Take us through why that decision was made.
Well, you know, at the end of the fourth quarter, we were thinking just run the clock out, go to overtime. Then we hit a couple runs. We caught them off balance. You know, I wish we could have got a couple more yards down there so John could have a better chance of success. But then in the fourth quarter, we trust him. Clint Ratkovich is a pro. And he deserves to go to the Senior Bowl. He deserves to be all MAC. He has done a tremendous job for our offense, and I couldn't be more proud of him.
Coach, this is now your seventh win by one score incredible the way you guys are able to close out these games. Congratulations again. Northern Illinois, a winner in overtime over Buffalo. MAC West champs, the Huskies, getting it done on the road in Buffalo. For Colt Kubelik, I'm John Treffen. Good night from UB Stadium. What a thriller. Gotta love action.
This is SportsCenter at night.
Straight ahead, a clash of champions. Anthony Davis and Giannis face off in Milwaukee, while the Nets look to bounce back against the better-than-expected Cavs. The Cowboys and Chiefs headline. The NFL's Week 11 slate, why Dallas needs this win Sunday, and the challenge that KC's defense presents. Plus, the must-see event just days away. Crawford versus Porter. What they're both saying ahead of the welterweight bouts.
Started doing it.
Swinging it around like it's a jungle gym.
I'm not too familiar with home days. I'm not. Like... Okay.
We'll get to the NFL and whether he might start in just a minute. That's actually a really big story. Good evening. Welcome to SportsCenter with Kevin Connors. I'm Zubin Mehenti. You know, Kev, the NBA's biggest buzz the last 24 hours has been that article where Giannis questioned his long-term future in Milwaukee. But more pressing, the immediate future for two of the NBA's biggest contenders that hardly right now resemble that.
Yeah, the Bucks outside the top 10 teams in the East, awful at home this year. The Lakers, no chemistry, barely above.